Hello, everybody, and welcome in for a franchise first, a video live stream from McMoran Place here in Port Huron, Michigan, located on the St. Clair River, just yards away, or meters, depending on which unit of measuring system you'd like to use, from Canada. Here, the Black Bears will play their only game of the season against the Port Huron Prowlers, scheduled to drop the puck at 7:05 tonight. The Black Bears looking to get back in the win column. They lost two consecutive games in regulation last weekend against the Watertown Wolves in tight checking games both nights, something that Coach Sherwood was sure to mention out to the guys and was talking with me a little bit about it, and hopefully the guys saw that as a humbling experience that anybody can beat anybody on any given night. First place, fifth place, sixth place, second place, it doesn't matter. You got to show up ready to do your job. You're listening to the Triple Cities Family Dental pregame show. Triple Cities Family Dental always makes your smile their priority. Schedule an appointment by calling them today so you can go in and see them at 607-545-4148. Prowlers and Black Bears coming up around the corner just 5 minutes past the hour. Don't go anywhere, folks. More on the Triple Cities Family Dental pregame show tonight as we go through the injuries and scratches, the starting lineups, and tonight's keys to the game. All that and more coming up in just a little bit. Don't go anywhere. We're right back on YouTube in 90 seconds.
The Black Bears are heading on the road for a while to close down the 2023-24 season, but they will be back at home Friday, April 5th, and Saturday, April 6th, to take on the Danbury Hattricks. Make sure to join us for an action-packed weekend and join the Black Bears as they push for the playoffs. Grab your tickets now at binghamtonblackbears.com.
There once was a ship that put to sea, and the name of the ship was the Billy O.T. The winds blew harder, bowed it down.
I have concerns.
Are there still health risks associated with COVID if I don't get a vaccine?
Does getting the vaccine protect others around me?
The answer is yes. Getting the COVID vaccine protects you from serious illness and those around you that you may expose, especially those with certain health issues. Ask your healthcare professional about your concerns in the easiest way for you to get a vaccine. Remember, it's not just COVID.
Welcome back in. Sorry about that little technical mishap. Had to re-up our quality of the stream tonight since we were used to the 480p that we were trying to stream from Watertown the other night. We're back now to 1080. I do apologize for that mishap. I am engineer, producer, broadcaster, and analyst tonight here, so wearing many hats up here at the famous Doc Emrick broadcast booth. Here at Port Huron, legendary NHL and Olympic announcer Doc Emrick got his start here with the Port Huron Flags. And we very excited for the help from Will Wiggleman to help us out, give us a little bit of history tonight, getting us set up with the cameras. So now we will be getting ready for hockey tonight here on the road, Prowlers and Black Bears. Taking a look at tonight's injuries and scratches for the Black Bears, brought to you by the Court Gesture Athletic Club. Brody Thornton, Don Oliveri, Cameron Clark, Scott Romakers, and Andrew Utoro, five bodies out of the lineup tonight for Binghamton. Don Oliveri still on the 15-day IR. He is scheduled to come off of that next week and hoping to see him in a couple of games as the Black Bears will begin three games in four nights next week, beginning Wednesday in Elmira. Very quick turnaround at this point of the season for Binghamton. So we will take another time out, come back with more. Triple Cities Family Dental pregame show continues to truck on as the players start to make their way out towards the gate for today. And we will be back after this.
Like that calls for a real celebration.
Oh yeah.
Getting your hands on an all-new CF Moto side-by-side or four-wheeler is now easier than ever at ExciteMotorsports.com. Purchase your next power sports vehicle with our new, easy, and quick online buying experience. Browse inventory on ExciteMotorsports.com. Buy, get approved for financing, and e-sign online right from your phone. Ride, have your new power sport vehicle delivered to your home the next day at no extra charge. Browse, buy, ride. Fun starts here at ExciteMotorsports.com.
Welcome back in, everybody. Getting ready for warm-ups tonight. As you see, that is, in fact, a flame on the ice. Here signifying that it is time for the teams to make their way out onto the ice, and that's also used for the starting lineup for the Port Huron Prowlers. Starting tonight for the Binghamton Black Bears, second line looking a little bit differently. Austin Thompson on the left wing, Connor Smith on the opposite side, Jesse Anderson in the middle, up front playing forward tonight, and JT Walters and Colin Fitzgerald paired up tonight on the blue line. So a little bit of shuffling the lines for the Black Bears here tonight. They will make their way out of the tunnel here momentarily. Up front, and the top line of Connor Foley, Austin Federally, and Dan Chartrand for Port Huron. On defense, they got a new guy back there, Dominic Lubert, an Adrian College Bulldog, the NCAA Division III version of the Bulldogs, making his pro debut here tonight with Port Huron. Not too far away from Adrian College. We're going to have a lot of Bulldogs in attendance tomorrow night up in Motor City, as always. And I believe Adam Heinzel is the final member of that starting lineup tonight. Those are the starters for the Binghamton Black Bears and Port Huron Prowlers. Binghamton coached by Brant Sherwood. Port Huron coached by Matt Graham, who has played games this year for the Prowlers. In fact, Mr. Graham has played in 42 games, 7 goals and 32 assists. Last night against the River Dragons, he did not play. He is behind the bench tonight, I've been told, once again for the Port Huron Prowlers. Home team making their way out onto the ice. We will step aside, come back, get you ready for the Dragon Billiards first period. Don't go anywhere, folks. More coming up right after this.
When you care about something, you take care to protect it. The family that depends on you and the future you're planning for them.
You'll have your own college stories too someday.
With sound advice, smart strategies, and a broad variety of life insurance options, Security Mutual can help provide for the people you care about and also help you reach your financial goals.
It's a sound plan. The time to start thinking about college
and retirement is now.
Security Mutual Life, the company that cares.
Advancements in new clinical therapies are made possible by heroes like you. Velocity Clinical Research is looking for volunteers to participate in clinical research studies. Compensation is provided. There's a Velocity location near you on Old Vestal Road in Vestal. Learn more about participating and becoming a Velocity Medical Hero today.
Whether you're a high school or college athlete or a weekend warrior, Guthrie is the area's premier sports medicine program, offering injury evaluation, concussion management, physical therapy, and more. With a full team of providers across New York and Pennsylvania offering same or next day appointments, Guthrie gets you back in the game as quickly as possible. Call the Guthrie Sports Medicine team today at 866-GUTHRIE or learn more at guthrie.org/sportsmed.
Welcome back in, everybody. Here, Prowlers have just taken the ice. Lights are down, and we are about ready to start tonight's Dragon Beards Instruction first period. But before we do, it's time for the presentation of the National Anthem. When we come back, hockey for the Black Bears right around the corner. Welcome in, everybody, once again for another edition of Black Bears Hockey here on YouTube. Brooks Hill flying solo tonight with the Black Bears up in Michigan. The push for the playoffs continues on. The Black Bears already having wrapped up their positioning in the playoffs. They are the number one seed in the Empire Division, no matter what happens the rest of the way. But that doesn't mean they want to add some more wins to their total. They're currently at 33. Last year, that set a franchise record, and they're going to try to break that with the final eight games remaining this season. Big thanks to our friends over at the Prowlers, Will Wiggleman and his entire team, the director of media, also their broadcaster, for allowing us to hook into their camera tonight. Everything that you will see on camera is not operated by me. It'll probably have a heavy shift on Prowlers on the ice, but we're very thankful that we could have this up on the air as we are officially underway here in the Dragon Billiards Instruction first period. A couple of Bulldogs out there on the ice, and that was Lubert, the Prowlers Adrian College Bulldog, who gloved that one down through the neutral zone, and away we go. Federley giving chase, but Colin Fitzgerald took a better angle over towards the puck, and he will exit the zone. This is the only time these teams will match up this season, unless they both meet in the Commissioner's Cup Finals. One time this year compared to the four that we saw last year. It's a turnover, and now Gavin Yates comes down the middle of the ice. Lost a handle on it as he tried to feather it over towards Tyson Kirkby. Just about 45 seconds gone here in the first period. New guy Chase McArdle, also for Port Huron, wearing 55 in gold. These are their alternate jerseys tonight, getting that puck deep. Behind the net is Connor McAnamaw, tonight's starter for the Black Bears. He's facing off with Makar Sokolov. More on that at our next whistle. Yates flies into the zone. Goes down to a knee. Bond pinching in, trying to join the rush along with the top line of Kirkby and Tosto tonight. That line staying the same for the third consecutive game as we have an icing call here. 8:40 left to go in period number one. And Tosto with four goals in his first two games, two goals each night against the Wolves last week. also had an assist as well. First line just going off on a line change there. And now the third line will come on out. Faceoff is pulled back, but looks like we have a premature whistle. And this faceoff is going to be moved back out to the neutral zone. So how about that? Port Huron will win this faceoff back. Heinzel overskates it. Somero will give a shove to Scantleberry, but Scantleberry crunched by Dan Stone. That's two for the price of one for the Black Bears, being physical early here in this one. Stone able to quickly reverse it, plays it over to the centerman now. Josh Fletcher goes out wide, and there's the first save of the night for Makar Sokoloff. Let's get to tonight's goaltending matchup brought to you by the Thompson & Johnson Equipment Company, always elevating your expectations. Makar Sokoloff, who just made that save, is 6-6-3 on the year, a .401 goals against average and a save percentage of .887. Facing off tonight with the Black Bears, Connor McInanima, 15-2-4, a straight goals against average of .234 and a save percentage of .920. Looks like there was a little bit of confusion on where the faceoff was going to be lined up there. But puck is dropped and one ahead by Dalton Jay, and the Prowlers come into the zone. Scantleberry throws one on target. That McInanima has a turn to make his first save of the contest as well. So the Black Bears arrived in Michigan yesterday around 7:30 after dropping our stuff off at the hotel, able to come over and come to the arena and see the Prowlers take on the Columbus River Dragons last night. Very chippy affair between the two sides. And Columbus was able to win that game 4-0. Port Huron just could not get anything going on the power play. More on the power play when the opportunity presents itself a little bit later on tonight. Shot blocked by the defenseman out in front for the Black Bears, and Connor Smith trying to go on the stretch path. It pinballs around a couple of players and ends up back in the Binghamton end. They are trying to send Austin Thompson, who had the game-winning goal last time the Black Bears were in this building last season. Late regulation third period goal for Austin Thompson allowed the Black Bears to win that game 4-3. Foley a shot snared by McInanima, and he will hang on. 2 minutes and 35 seconds gone. Shots favoring the home team so far, 2-1. Crowd still filling in here on a Friday night. Prowlers busy this week, and they're playing Thursday, Friday, and Saturday with Easter Sunday off. This week for the Michigan team, a shot deflected right on. I believe it went off the shoulder or the crossbar, possibly both, of McInanima. Binghamton now skating out with Tosto. Fitzgerald joining the rush. Doesn't like the numbers. Instead, this one gets pulled back into the other end. Chartrand elevates it high to the red line right in front of the penalty boxes, which are a little oddly placed here at McMoran Place. You'll see that when we have somebody zoomed in on the penalty box. It's in between the red line and the blue line. 2-on-1 now. Chartrand coming over, and a kick save made by McInanima. Port Huron now cycling the puck. Bartlett, that's Ross Bartlett, the former Motor City Rocker, throws one off the leg of Tyson Kirkby, thrown back into the neutral zone. Chartrand trying to get around Fitzgerald. It's poked away by the young defenseman. And Gavin Yates will pull the puck from behind his own net and start the breakout for the Black Bears. Gavin Yates hits a rough spot in the center of the ice as Motor City does touch the line off sides. 6:20 left to go here in the opening period. That's our first whistle in quite a while. Teams going back and forth with each other. Ross Bartlett, former Motor City Rocker, beginning to produce regularly here this season with Port Huron, as that puck will take a favorable bounce for the Black Bears, forcing Sokoloff to make a stoppage on it with 6:12 left to go here in the period. First period always brought to you by our friends over at Dragon Billiards Instruction. Learn, shop, and repair all things billiards at their store in Vestal, or visit them online anytime at dragonbilliardsinstruction.com. Third line out there for Coach Sherwood. Josh Fletcher centering that line. Who wins it back cleanly to Dakota Bond. Throws it toward the net, just missing on the left side. Scannelberry trying to push one over to the red line. Bartlett fanned on it. Both teams trying to pick up a loose puck in the neutral zone. Dakota Bond with his second big hit of the game on Dalton Jay. As this one's pressured, held in at the line. They say on sides. Fletcher touched up, not knowing that he didn't need to. And he gets back to the Bulldog defenseman in Dan Stone. Somero trying to hit the far man, and Fletcher goes off for a change. Port Huron intercepts, and Jay goes one on two. He tries a drag shot, hit a rough spot once again. Coach Sherwood made note that a lot of rough spots in the ice here tonight during morning skate, as icing is called, against the Black Bears. Like I said, always be careful. Don't assume that the puck is going to stay on your tape the entire time while you are carrying it. So this face-off to the right of Mackinanima. Connor Foley on his power hand, playing in his 10th game as a Prowler this season. He loses this face-off. And Dan Weber able to get that puck deep after taking a hit from Dominic Luber. Luber got the worst of that one. This one's touched in for Mackinanima. Liam Anderson spinning around, and he's taken down, no call. Federally going in a beautiful bat check on a cross-ice pass by Connor Smith, denying Luber. Anderson coming ahead over to Thompson in the skates. No shot will come of it. Anderson, though, that's Liam holding. His shot kicked out by Sokolov. Binghamton with this transition was their best chance of the game so far in this one. Port Huron goes for a quick change. Smith touches it ahead. Thompson now going after it behind the net. Clearing a tip, fanned on. Smith holding, has it on his power side, looking for Thompson. He's interfered with from behind. Coach Sherwood looking for a call, none provided. 5.5 gone here from McMoran Place for the only time this season for the Black Bears. This puck comes out to Mackinanima. Looks like they waved off icing. Walters using his big frame, gets past Johnson. Giving chase, gets around to Cumbus, but in the process loses the handle on it. Now 2-on-1 for Port Huron. They come back the other way. They're in the process of a line change. Fitzgerald blocks the pass. Bartlett calling for the puck behind their own net. It overskated. Scannelberry reverses it too far outside the zone. Port Huron is offsides, and they will touch up. Well, Walters tries to cut through the middle. Bartlett with a nifty move around Yates, and his shot is absorbed by Mackinanima. 13:42 left to go here. We are back in just a little bit. Black Bears and Prowlers looking for the game's first goal. Don't go anywhere, folks. More coming up after this.
When you care about something, you take care to protect it. The family that depends on you and the future you're planning for them.
You'll have your own college stories too someday.
With sound advice, smart strategies, and a broad variety of life insurance options, Security Mutual can help provide for the people you care about and also help you reach your financial goals.
It's a sound plan. The time to start thinking about college
and retirement is now.
Security Mutual Life, the company that cares.
Welcome back, everybody. Dragon Billiards Instruction first period here from McMoran Place. The only time this year where you will find the Black Bears up in Port Huron. Tomorrow, the Black Bears will take on the Motor City Rockers at 6:05 on a Saturday night showdown. Then they're done for the weekend. Travel home, get ready for a Wednesday night tilt in Elmira. Face-off won by Tyson Kirkby. Now skates over the blue line with it. trying to get it deep. That's Heinzel with the puck behind the net. And Gavin Yates could not hold it in at the line along with Dan Stone. Scantleberry coming in, trying to wrap chance that one around Dakota Bond, but Bond does a good job of holding the far side post. Stone knocks this one ahead to Tosto, and now Yates starts the breakout in front of his own net. Ahead for Tyson Kirkby, cross ice for Tosto, right wing side, back over to the centerman, looking for Yates on a give-and-go action. Couldn't get there, and Scantleberry throws it in deep at the red line. Port Huron goes for a change. 7 minutes in, searching for the game's first goal. Kirkby got a piece of it. The defense goes for a switcheroo for the Black Bears. And Weber and Liam Anderson come out. Connor Foley, 13 in yellow. Separated from the puck by Dan Weber. Stefan, the 10th forward tonight. His first touch of the puck, could not get it out. Luber back down low for Foley. Weber switching it around. And the Black Bears looking to trying to establish their game. They haven't gotten to it yet so far in the first 7.5 minutes. Here's the big guy in Kyle Stefan. He goes charging in past all the Port Huron defenders. Couldn't connect on a pass to Somero, held in by a pinching Logar just outside the faceoff dot. Back into the neutral zone. Binghamton will dump this puck right back in, and Stefan gets chasing out to the opposite side. This time, Logar able to settle it down. Throws it towards the net, hit a skate, turnaround bid, denied in the blue paint, and it's cleared out by Sokolov. Liam Anderson off the bottom of the glove of the Prowlers goaltender. So far, best shift of the night for the Black Bears, and it's coming from the third line and the 10th forward, along with the third pair of defensemen. Logar with the takeaway, puts it back out towards the red line, and Port Huron will backtrack as they call for some reinforcements. Johnson in the skates of Thompson. Try saying that 5 times fast. Nowhere to go for the Prowlers. They retreat, go again. Chartrand chips it on ahead, but Colin Fitzgerald catches up to it. Fitzgerald finding his 3-year partner for the Black Bears. You check that. I thought that was Tyson Kirkby. It was Josh Fletcher for a second. The long hair really does get to you, even when you're so high up like I am here tonight. 11:07 left to go. Shots 5 for Port Huron, 4 for the Black Bears. Really missing my color partners, Cole Parenti and Alex Jones here tonight. Having to realize how much time I really have to fill when I'm hanging out by myself. Faceoff won back by the Black Bears, and Fitzgerald has a wrister that will run a couple of seconds off the clock. Stay in the same spot. And the second line now out on the ice, so Jesse Anderson moves up to forward. JT Walters back in the lineup this weekend. And he's paired up with Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald trying to go across for Connor Smith. It hit a stick on the way through. That's enough for Chartrand to skate away. He goes one-on-one with Walters. Decumbis is the trail man. Couldn't hang on to the puck as it was knocked away by Connor Smith. This play is offsides, and that'll draw a late shove from Heinzel with a couple of extra whacks on Thompson. And we got our first little tussle of the night down low in the corner. So Port Huron going to argue that Thompson shot the puck after he heard the whistle. And Austin Thompson's helmet just ripped right off his head by Adam Heinzel. And they're going to send Austin Thompson to the penalty box. Looks like Adam Heinzel and Dan Chartrand are going to join them. So two Port Huron penalties look like are coming up here. Time and the infractions are at 9:14. 2 for Port Huron, 1 for Binghamton. All in the first period here, brought to you by Dragon Billiards Instruction. So it looks like the Black Bears could be headed to the Henny Hard Seltzer power play They would be missing Austin Thompson on the power play unit. I only see four Prowlers on the ice. They only have 2 minutes up on the board. We'll have to wait and see how they want to distribute this one. So Austin Thompson, Dan Chartran, and Adam Heinzel all get 2 minute minors for roughing. That according to the league website. And now we have a longer discussion on where to put the faceoff than that entire scrum took place. Thinks this would probably lead to a great transition here that tonight's officials are referees Kevin Mullen and Dallas Mitchell, Mark Jackson, and Jonathan Paradise, the linesman. So that was a neutral zone faceoff, and that was probably the right call with penalties on both sides here. Binghamton on a Henny hard seltzer power play, which is top of the FPHL, and they are going against the worst penalty kill in the league. Logar in the bumper just sent it wide. 73.5% on the kill this season for Port Huron. That is 11 out of 11. Bond. Top of the umbrella, playing it over to Kirkby. This unit stayed out on the ice a lot tonight, or earlier this morning after Morning State had concluded working through some plays. Yates holds it in at the line temporarily, but then second effort, Connor Foley able to knock this one back out into the neutral zone. First 45 seconds gone on this power play for the Black Bears. Kirkby gets to the goal line, reverses around, and everybody gets set back up. Bond. Skating in, has a shot thrown into the chest of Sokolov. Rebound knocked out towards the blue line. Good job by Logar and Yates holding that one in. Now Yates and Kirkby switching spots across the ice. Yates cuts into the middle. Trying to draw a crowd, trying to hit Tosto, who did such a good job last week of staying in front of the net and cashing in some rebounds. Kirkby skate to stick, back door for Bond. Loose puck, and it is swallowed up by Sokolov. Bond pinching in on the back post, almost had the game's first goal. But the Prowlers hang tight for the moment. Sends us to a media timeout. 9:30 left to go here in the period. Binghamton looking for a power play goal to get on the board.
You can experience gig speeds with Greenlight Networks. Our reliable fiber connection provides fast, affordable internet, so you can accomplish more in less time. We're expanding coverage in many places in the Southern Tier, and we want to be your internet provider. Visit greenlightnetworks.com and click on Check Availability to see if we're in your area. Greenlight Networks, fast, affordable internet in your hometown.
For discounted name brand clothing and footwear for the whole family, Homer Men and Boys Store is the place to shop. In business since 1951, our woman-owned family business is known for treating their customers like family. And there's nothing more important to us than backing every sale with friendly service. Come visit us to see the largest pair of jeans in the world. Come see what we have for you.
Welcome back in, everybody. Black Bears YouTube here from McMoran Place for the first time ever. Black Bears have 35 seconds left to go in the power play. Brought to you by Henny Hard Seltzer, second unit. Look like they're going to clean this one up the rest of the way, see if they can have any magic left to go here. Port Huron gets over to a loose puck, and they will fire this one down the entire length of the ice. As Kirkby knocked down a little bit Backside of the net, no call. 5 seconds left to go. Binghamton puts it between the defensemen, and the power play is over for the Black Bears. They are officially 0-for-1. And the Prowlers are back to full strength, 5-on-5. So now Josh Fletcher dumps this one in, kicked away by Sokoloff. Binghamton trying to sustain some pressure after they got 4 shots on goal that last power play sequence. So did everything but score. Weber coming away with a takeaway, driving it back towards the line. He would have put himself offsides if that pass connected, but it works out either way. Black Bears now coming back the other way. Bartlett couldn't connect with Schumacher on the feed, and now third line right back out on there after the power play. Stefan and Schumacher tie up. Somero knocking the loose puck away from the corner behind the net. Stefan, power move to the front of the net. And Sokoloff made the save. Weber looking for his 5th goal of the season. He has one deflected by Dalton Jay. Ends up on Anderson's stick down near the goal line. Somero spinning it around for Fletcher. Fletcher trying to cut towards the middle of the ice, held on to, as this puck is going to be chopped at and deflect into the bench of Port Huron, out of play with 7:34 left to go here in the period. Don't go anywhere during the intermission, folks. We have a look at the FPHL standings here tonight. And also, out-of-town scoreboard. Binghamton Hockey Booster Club highlights. All that and more coming up during the first intermission. And looks like we're going to have a stoppage momentarily. Looks like they're going to try to fix a dislodged pane of glass. That's what I'm going to go with. We're taking a timeout. Come back with more right after this, folks.
Are you ready to take your billiards game to a whole new level? Dragon Billiards Instruction and Pro Shop has everything you need to impress your friends and crush your opponents. American Q Sports certified coach Kim the Dragon Young is now accepting new students. From novices to pros, the Dragon helps you find your best game with in-person or online instruction available worldwide. Need help with stance, stroke, or alignment and aiming? We've got you covered. Looking for advanced cue control techniques and trick shots? No problem. Follow us on Facebook at Dragon Billiards Instruction and Instagram at Dragon Billiards Kim for free daily tips and drills, upcoming tournaments and events, as well as exciting contests and giveaways. Subscribe on Patreon for personalized video content. Visit our online pro shop for the lowest prices on the highest quality pool cues, accessories, and Dragon Billiards gear. Dragon Billiards Instruction and Pro Shop, breathing fire into your game.
Welcome back in, everybody. 7:34 left to go in the first period, brought to you by Dragon Billiards Instruction. They have members of the ice crew and arena staff here at McMarron Place attending to this dislodged pane of glass. It's not broken and not shattered. They're just trying to reconnect everything. They sent the teams to their respective benches, and they are working on it tentatively right now. Got a couple of games going on in the FPHL tonight. Only one starting at 7:05 was this one. A lot of games taking a start at 7:30 as they are replacing one of the stanchions right now. Watertown Danbury just about underway. They're getting ready to drop the puck. And Danbury, just like they are, not too far down the road in Fraser, just north of Detroit, as the Rockers are taking on the Columbus River Dragons. River Dragons are actually back here in McMarron Place tomorrow night to cap off their Easter weekend here at Port Huron's barn. Carolina and Blue Ridge just underway down in Winston-Salem at 0-0. And then at 8:30 Eastern time, Baton Rouge takes on Mississippi. That's a look at the out-of-town scoreboard while we had a momentary pause in the action. Got players circling around the bench area, And while members of the ice crew are replacing the stanchion for the glass, we've just been given the thumbs up that we're good to go. So how about that? We don't need to go to commercial, folks. We're stay right here. Get that beautiful scoreboard, courtesy of our friend EJ Worth, back up on the big screen. And there it is, 7:34 left to go here. Offensive zone draw for the Black Bears. Still searching for the game's first goal, Binghamton. Out shooting the home team, 10-5 so far here in this one. Played around the wall, Weber will pinch in. Loses the handle on it, and Parsons trying to skate this one out. First opportunity denied, and now Heinzel, fresh out of the penalty box, along with Austin Thompson as well, giving pressure. See if that is a continuing theme throughout tonight's contest. Thompson trying to get it over to Connor Smith. Couldn't handle the puck, and now Weber able to catch an indecisive Heinzel. In no man's land and thrown all the way back towards Liam Anderson. You get a good look at him behind McAnanamaw's net. And the Black Bears break this one out. Anderson crossing over the blue line. Starting and stopping outside the faceoff circle. He's crunched up into the wall by Chase McArdle, one of the new guys this weekend for the Prowlers. Now McArdle crossing over with Federle 2-on-2. His pass is blocked by Liam Anderson. Fitzgerald pinning up the puck against the wall. This one's chipped up into the net. And out of play with 6:24 left to go here in the opening frame. Friday night crowd mingling their way throughout the concourse and the luxury areas here at McMarron Place. Have a beer garden located right beside the visitor's bench. That's neat. You don't see that every day. This puck played out towards the line, held in by McArdle. He's got a wrister. That McAnanamaw made the save. Rebound. How did that one not go in? Connor Foley with a yawning net on the blocker side of McAnanamaw. Maybe rang one off the post. 6 minutes left to go here in the opening frame. Still searching for the game's first goal. And we have a penalty coming up against the Prowlers once again. McAnanamaw started to make his way over towards the bench. Didn't get too far. And with 5:53 left to go, Connor Foley is going to sit down in the penalty box. Black Bears on their second power play of the night, brought to you by Henny Hard Seltzer. .14:07 time of the penalty. Black Bears looking for the game's first goal on their second power play. Looks like the second unit is going to begin this power play opportunity for the Black Bears as Josh Fletcher wins the faceoff. It's settled down by Smith, and Smith has a shot fought off by Sokolov. Jesse Anderson playing forward tonight and acting as a forward on this second power play unit along with Thompson, Smith, and Fletcher. Dan Stone, the lone defenseman. Thompson tried to go cross ice for Smith. It was knocked down but held in by Jesse. Binghamton trying to get set up. Fletcher gets towards the front of the net. A wrist shot by Smith goes wide. Thompson holds it in. His shot was blocked by Luber, and Dan Stone is able to get this puck deep. Fletcher now give and go a little bit. Two-man game behind the net of Sokolov for Fletcher and Anderson. Stone skates in, back over to Smith. A one-timer kicked out with the pad of Sokolov. Fletcher down low. He's got an open man in Thompson, fanned on a one-time partially. Prowler's able to kick this one back out towards the neutral zone, and they're going to change three out of their four. Dan Stone, quick re-entry. 50 seconds left to go on the power play. Loose puck is dove out on top of by Sokolov. And that sends us to our final media timeout of the period. 4:40 left to go, 47 seconds left to go on the power play for the Black Bears. Back with you after this.
Mm-hmm.
Advancements in new clinical therapies are made possible by heroes like you. Velocity Clinical Research is looking for volunteers to participate in clinical research studies. Compensation is provided. There's a Velocity location near you on Upper Front Street in Binghamton. Learn more about participating and becoming a Velocity Medical Hero today.
Toyota Trucks. Let's go places.
Welcome back, everybody. Brooks Hill flying solo in a goalless game here so far between the Prowlers and the Black Bears. 47 seconds left to go on Binghamton's second power play of the night. Shots are 13-6 favoring the visitors. First unit is now out there for what supposedly will be the remainder of the power play, as a couple of seconds shave off there, as Kirby won that faceoff forward. Faceoff won back by Kirby over to Yates. Yates will circle around, wait for everybody to get set up, as Dakota Bond, top of the umbrella, playing it over for Kirby, a shot off the outside of the net. Tosto is camped out in front, providing a screen. Held in temporarily by the Black Bears, but now shorthanded comes the Prowlers, and Port Huron is on the board first. A shorthanded goal for Vinny DeCumbis, his seventh goal of the season, and his third shorthanded goal of the campaign for the Prowlers, as the home team up 1-0. An unassisted goal at 15:44 of the period. So Binghamton thought they were going to keep the puck in at the zone. It was knocked down by Logar. And DeCumbis was able to get it past Bond at the blue line. Went all the way down the ice by himself. Now Binghamton looking for the equalizer. Yates on the feed from Kirkby. Misses the net, and the Prowlers back to even strength. It's a shorthanded goal. Kirkby over to Tosto, a shot, and Sokolov will hold on. And they gave out an assist on that. That's actually pretty funny. Alex Johnson gets an assist. Excuse me, that is DeCumbis' fourth goal of the season, not the seventh. So Port Huron up 1-0 with the game's first goal coming shorthanded. Faceoff won back by the Prowlers, and they're now going to look for more. Chase McArdle. That's their first goal of the weekend. They did not score last night. And a one touch for Scantleberry. And Mack and Animon makes the save. Back across. Scantleberry couldn't handle the pass from Bartlett. Floated on him too much. Port Huron lost 4-0 last night. And they grab one after 60 minutes of goalless hockey last night. Johnson D-to-D with McArdle. A shot fought off by Mack and Animon. Pawed down by Weber. Binghamton trying to exit the zone. Somero plays it out towards the middle where Liam Anderson was waiting for it. Here circle back, and the Black Bears are in the process of a line change right now. Steffen still shaking that rust off a little bit. Now joining the rush with Somero and Jesse Anderson. Somero's shot paddled away by the netminder. Steffen going to work down low. Falls over the skate of Dalton J. Nothing there. And now Federally playing it over for Farley. Farley ahead for one more. Freeburn, power move to the front. Mack and Animal held the post. Puck still available. Referee says play on. And Somero doing battle with Liam Freeburn. Team's trying to pull this puck out of the kick plate. Finally makes its way around. Somero pulled it out but stolen away by Port Huron. They get it back down low for Freeborn. Freeborn and Fitzgerald get their hands tied up, spun around a little bit, but no worse for wear. Four-man pile up, and JT Walters finally has some space to backhand this one out. Past Heinzel in a skate race with Thompson. No icing, says the linesman. And Beamton, though, cannot hold the puck in. Lane back across, and Freeborn a shot blocked off the skate of Austin Thompson. Check that, Connor Smith, and he's favoring that right leg. So he gets over to the bench. New player comes on. Nearing that minute of regulation here in period number one. Thompson reversing it around. Didn't see DeCumis behind the net. He tried to center up Luber, but Dan Stone read the play like he always does, and he skates the puck at the red line and gets it deep. 15-9, shots on goal, but where it matters, Port Huron up by one. Kirkby now, self-pass off the wall, tried to center it off the goalie. He has it, and he lost his edge down near the pipe. A couple of big guys getting tied up as Dan Stone got caught in a two-on-one. Evan Foley playing it back, and Kirkby intercepts, trying to hit Tostow. Trying to locate the puck, couldn't find him in stride. Tostow, a low angle shot, saved by Sokolov. Rebound sent wide by Yates. Bond still around the puck, though, as we play on. Sokolov with a save. Yates over to the rebound. 20 seconds left to go. Shot through traffic from Kirkby. Pinballed around. And skated out by Port Huron. 14 seconds left to go. Scannelberry. Pinned up against the corner. Backhander denied by McAnanima. Weber pulls it behind the net, pulling it away from harm's way. Final push for the Black Bears. 4 seconds and 3, 2, then 1. Yates with the final look, and the horn sounds. And that is the end of the first period. Port Huron up 1-0. As the Prowlers score shorthanded. And rare situation here. At McMoran Place, both teams go out the same tunnel, so the home team will go first this time around. So they're waiting for everybody dressed in gold to make their way to the locker room. 17 shots on goal for the Black Bears that period, 10 by the Prowlers, one shorthanded tally for Port Huron. Nothing that you can fault, really, just a bang-bang play at a 50-50 puck at the blue line. So the Black Bears will look to tie things up in the second period. Don't go anywhere, folks. We have the Excite Motorsports Intermission Report coming up in a few minutes. Don't go anywhere. More coming up on YouTube right after this.
Are you ready to take your billiards game to a whole new level? Dragon Billiards Instruction and Pro Shop has everything you need to impress your friends and crush your opponents. American Q Sports certified coach Kim the Dragon Young is now accepting new students. From novices to pros, the Dragon helps you find your best game with in-person or online instruction available worldwide. Need help with stance, stroke, or alignment and aiming? We've got you covered. Looking for advanced cue control techniques and trick shots? No problem. Follow us on Facebook at Dragon Billiards Instruction and Instagram at Dragon Billiards Kim for free daily tips and drills, upcoming tournaments and events, as well as exciting contests and giveaways. Subscribe on Patreon for personalized video content. Visit our online pro shop for the lowest prices on the highest quality pool cues, accessories, and Dragon Billiards gear. Dragon Billiards Instruction and Pro Shop, breathing fire into your game.
When you care about something, you take care to protect it. The family that depends on you and the future you're planning for them.
You'll have your own college stories too someday.
With sound advice, smart strategies, and a broad variety of life insurance options, Security Mutual can help provide for the people you care about and also help you reach your financial goals.
It's a sound plan. The time to start thinking about college
and retirement is now.
Security Mutual Life, the company that cares.
Get access to exclusive player events, monthly parties, and road trips to away Black Bears games. This is what you get when you become a member of the Binghamton Black Bears Booster Club. Stop by the Booster Club table behind Section 4 at the next Black Bears home game, pick up a 50-50 ticket, and sign up to join for just $10. Stay up to date on the Booster Club by liking their Facebook page, facebook.com/Binghamton Black Bears Booster Club. Monthly meetings with players, road trips, and a whole lot of fun when you join the Black Bears Booster Club.
Advancements in new clinical therapies are made possible by heroes like you. Velocity Clinical Research is looking for volunteers to participate in clinical research studies. Compensation is provided. There's a Velocity location near you on Upper Front Street in Binghamton. Learn more about participating and becoming a Velocity Medical Hero today.
Wanting more Black Bears hockey? Season tickets are on sale. Visit BinghamtonBlackBears.com or call the front office at 607-722-7367 to learn more.
You can experience gig speeds with Greenlight Networks. Our reliable fiber connection provides fast, affordable internet, so you can accomplish more in less time. We're expanding coverage in many places in the Southern Tier, and we want to be your internet provider. Visit greenlightnetworks.com and click on Check Availability to see if we're in your area. Greenlight Networks, fast, affordable internet in your hometown.
Toyota Trucks. Let's go places.
Welcome back in, everybody, for another edition of the Excite Motorsports Intermission Report. Brooks Hill flying solo here as we get you ready for more exciting action. We got a couple of things that we can talk about here tonight. As you see, the bike race is going on during intermission here, home of the Port Huron Prowlers, McMarin Place. Binghamton down 1-0, not where you want to be after the opening 20 minutes, but I would say the Black Bears did have the better of chances in that opening period. They had 17 shots on goal, some of them more challenging than others for Makar Sokolov, but the home team is up 1-0. Let's take a look at the Columbia Mutual Life Insurance stat sheet. Columbia Mutual Life Insurance Company been protecting families in the Southern Tier for over 140 years. Shots on goal, we just got to 17 for Binghamton, 10 for Port Huron. Binghamton is 0 for 2 on the power play. Port Huron yet to have a man advantage yet tonight. And we'll see what they do with it when they get one. 1-0 is the scoring. Port Huron's Vincent DeCumbis and Alex Johnson connecting on a shorthanded goal. It was a breakaway for DeCumbis on a puck that was batted down from the blue line by Logar. Bond gets caught in no man's land a little bit. Do I pull the puck out, force everybody to reset? Do I try to keep it in, make the play? Port Huron made the better one. It happens. Nothing to fret about. Still 40 minutes of hockey left to go here in this one. Everything is just fine. Mackinanima, other than that, has looked very steady in the net so far with a couple of easy saves and denying two odd man opportunities for the Prowlers. Big thanks to everybody hanging out with us tonight in the YouTube chat. My friend EJ watching back at home in Binghamton or Friendsville tonight. Managing our social media while I am on the air. Making sure everything is running smoothly. And everybody listening around, we appreciate you tuning in once again. Glad I could be here with video feed for everybody here to see. We'll be interacting with the chat, I'm assuming, all night long, because I don't like talking forever. I like interacting with you guys. We do want to take this time to give a very special shout-out to Black Bear season ticket holder and one of our off-ice officials, Jeff Barrett. Not Jeff Barrett, that's the Watertown broadcaster, but I do want to give a shout-out to Jeff Barrett. He always does a great job. Jeff Bartlett for helping out the Black Bears today after morning skate, taking some of the guys over to the local sporting goods store with his car. He made the trip, and since the Black Bears don't have any cars with them here up in Port Huron since we drove the bus, big shout-out to Drock doing an excellent job as always. Jeff volunteered to take some of the guys out to the sporting goods store and help them pick up some last-minute things. So big shout-out to Jeff and the entire Bartlett family for helping out the Black Bears this weekend. We're taking time out. Come back with more here on the Excite Motorsports Intermission Report. Back with you after this.
For discounted name brand clothing and footwear for the whole family, Homer Men and Boys Store is the place to shop. In business since 1951, our woman-owned family business is known for treating their customers like family. And there's nothing more important to us than backing every sale with friendly service. Come visit us to see the largest pair of jeans in the world. Come see what we have for you.
All about you make me think of good things.
Good day.
Like calming tempers down.
Good day.
Passing them around.
So stand up and cheer. We'll pass you a beer. Good
day. Cheer a good-natured Canadian Pilsner.
Awestruck Premium Hard Cider, crafting transcendent, awe-inspiring liquid made and sealed right in Sydney, New York with New York State apples. Improve your day with Awestruck Premium Hard Cider. CryoWorks provides cryotherapy that uses nitrogen-cooled air to target specific areas of pain and inflammation. Local cryotherapy targets a specific area to deliver the same effects of the whole-body cryotherapy to that specific site. Treatments take 5 to 8 minutes, with a benefit exceeding that of hours of icing. Your Binghamton Black Bears, premier choice of cryotherapy, CryoWorks.
Stay in the swing of things with your golf game this winter and check out Fairways Indoor Golf Company. At Fairways, you can play any three state-of-the-art golf simulators, enjoy your favorite cocktail in the lounge by the fire, or watch your favorite sports team on over 9 82-inch TVs. The only slice you'll experience will be from the homemade pizza from the clubhouse kitchen. Bring your own clubs or use theirs. Get the golfer in your life a Fairways gift certificate. Tee off with Fairways Golf Company, 511 Hooper Road, Endwell, online at fairwaysindoor.golf.
Are you compassionate and interested in providing care to people with developmental disabilities? Check out a New York State career with Broome OPWDD. Enjoy great benefits such as job security, health insurance, retirement plan, paid time off, opportunities for advancement, and so much more. Positions as direct support professionals in the community or at a secure facility might be exactly the change of pace that you're looking for. For more information, call 607-240-4786 or go online to www.opwdd.ny.gov.
Go with a winner, Tech Guys Auto Sales.
We have a huge selection of vehicles and every tool available to fit everyone's credit needs. If you've been told no before,
I say no when it feels so good to say yes.
Get the vehicle you deserve.
Yes, that's awesome.
With our guaranteed credit approval program, which can easily be filled out online at jeffguys.com.
Tech Guys Auto Sales, Apple Lincoln. Go with a winner, Jeff Guys.
Are you planning on traveling to Binghamton for an upcoming Black Bears game? If so, check out La Quinta Inn and Suites by Wyndham for a night away from home. La Quinta Inn and Suites is a short drive from the arena and is conveniently located off of the Southern Tier Expressway and Highway 17 with easy access to Interstate 81 and the Vestal Parkway. La Quinta Inn and Suites by Wyndham at 581 Harry L. Drive, Johnson City. Reach them at 607-770-9333.
Advancements in new clinical therapies are made possible by heroes like you. Velocity Clinical Research is looking for volunteers to participate in clinical research studies. compensation is provided. There's a Velocity location near you on Old Vestal Road in Vestal. Learn more about participating and becoming a Velocity Medical Hero today.
Are you kidding me?
How do you do that?
Dude, I just got a new hot spring spa.
Carlisle has hot spring spas starting at $39.95. Come see how we make every day better by relaxing in a hot spring spa.
What happens to you today? You're shredding it.
Hot spring spas, baby.
Welcome back in, everybody. Excite Motorsports Intermission Report. Browse, ride, and buy. Free next day delivery to New York and Pennsylvania. You can visit them online anytime at excitemotorsports.com. While we have this opportunity here, thought we would check out the out-of-town scoreboard and find out what's going on across the FPHL here tonight before we get you ready for the second period. In Danbury, the Hattricks lead the Watertown Wolves 1-0 that game at the tail end of the first period. The Rockers have a 1-0 lead over the Columbus River Dragons. In Fraser, that's tomorrow's Black Bears opponent in Motor City. And we're still searching for the game's first goal over in Carolina between the Thunderbirds and the Bobcats. And Baton Rouge and Mississippi start at 8:30 Eastern Time. So no score between Thunderbirds and Bobcats. Rockers lead River Dragons 1-0. Hattricks lead the Wolves 1-0. And the Prowlers lead the Black Bears by the same score here in McMarron Place. Taking our final timeout of the Excite Motorsports Intermission Report. Come back for the second period brought to you by Greenlight Networks. Don't go anywhere, folks. More coming up right after this.
Whether you're a high school or college athlete or a weekend warrior, Guthrie is the area's premier sports medicine program, offering injury evaluation, concussion management, physical therapy, and more. With a full team of providers across New York and Pennsylvania offering same or next day appointments, Guthrie gets you back in the game as quickly as possible. Call the Guthrie Sports Medicine team today at 866-GUTHRIE or learn more at guthrie.org/sportsmed.
Are you looking for a new place to live? Lofts at JC is the official housing partner of the Binghamton Black Bears and the only luxury housing provider offering both 2- and 3-bedroom units fully furnished for a modern living lifestyle. Lofts at JC is centrally located in the heart of the Tri-Cities area, located at 128 Grand Avenue in Johnson City. Housing applications are accepted online at loftsatjc.com. Once again, that's loftsatjc.com.
Toyota Trucks. Let's go places.
Jersey, bring us the Hennies!
Yeah! All right, I got the Hennies.
That's me, Zoe.
Oh, yeah.
Cheers, baby.
A win like that calls for a real celebration.
Oh, yeah.
Magic 1017.
The best radio station.
Keeps getting better.
Better music selection.
Best ever.
Makes me feel better.
Number one for music and fun.
It's like the best ever.
Magic 1017. 100% local.
Getting your hands on an all-new CF Moto side-by-side or four-wheeler is now easier than ever at ExciteMotorsports.com. Purchase your next power sports vehicle with our new, easy, and quick online buying experience. Browse inventory on ExciteMotorsports.com. Buy, get approved for financing, and e-sign online right from your phone. Ride. Have your new power sport vehicle delivered to your home the next day at no extra charge. Browse, buy, ride. Fun starts here at ExciteMotorsports.com.
Experience the new way to watch your Black Bears play all season long at home and on the road free on YouTube.
You can experience gig speeds with Greenlight Networks. Our reliable fiber connection provides fast, affordable internet so you can accomplish more in less time. We're expanding coverage in many places in the Southern Tier, and we want to be your internet provider. Visit greenlightnetworks.com and click on Check Availability to see if we're in your area. Greenlight Networks, fast, affordable internet in your hometown.
Welcome back in, everybody. Brooks Hill flying solo tonight. 20 minutes up on the big board. Second period brought to you by our friends at Greenlight Networks, as always. Black Bears find themselves down by one. A shorthanded tally for Vincent DeCumbis from the Prowlers is the difference maker so far in this one. Only matchup of the season between the two sides. Opening face-off underway of the second period. And the Black Bears look to get back on top of the Prowlers here and get back in the win column here tonight. This one slapped around the wall, delayed off sides. Port Huron just throws it right back in. Connor Foley chops it off the wall. He's got Freeburn camped out right in front, but Mack and Animal holding the post. Give him no space. Shot wide, rebound cashed in. And the Prowlers, a very favorable bounce off of the inboard, able to knock one in, and they have a goal here in the first 32 seconds of the period. 2-0 Prowlers. So that period does not start the way you want to if you're the Black Bears. Now they find themselves down by a pair. Now Chartrand skates over to a loose puck, brushes off a hit from Dakota Bond, and Dan Stone able to skate this puck over towards the faceoff circle. He had it stolen away by DeCumbis, the first goal scorer in tonight's game. Now Kirkby does get it outside the blue line. Tosto throws it off a couple of skates where Sokolov has to reach out with his stick to play the puck. And this one coming down to McAnanima's net. No icing as Johnson beat out Stone for the race. Now Bartlett, power move to the front, rolled off of his stick. Yates picking it out of the corner, starting and stopping. And Yates will cross over. Kirkby, give and go. Yates wrapped down. No call. And Sokolov will put his mitt on top, and he will hang on for a whistle. So the Prowlers jumping off of the get-go here in period number two, an even strength goal. Liam Freeborn, Austin Federle, and Frank Schumacher connecting at 32 seconds, making it 2-0 Port Huron. Face off one back, and Weber has a shot that's caught once again by Sokolov. Ran a couple of seconds off the clock, 8:12 left to go here. Black Bears find themselves down by a pair. Shot number 11 of the night for Port Huron, the insurance goal. Binghamton with their 18th of the night from Dan Weber. Fletcher chases in off, stuff chance, heavy power wraparound move by Fletcher comes up empty-handed. Federle brushes off a hit from Somero. And now Farley throws one that's fought off by McEnanima. He punches that one into the corner. Binghamton trying to skate this one out. Somero able to throw it out. Delayed offsides is called. Federle was tied up with Somero. Binghamton from behind their own net. Able to get this puck out. Liam Anderson gets it deep. Defenseman will go for a line change. Blackbear is trying to come away on the forecheck with it. It gets knocked around. And Walters now, with plenty of time and space, goes towards the middle of the ice. Got to be careful of that from the defenseman, from the goal line up to the blue line, especially in the middle. Could lead to a turnover now. Walters off the skate and right in stride for Jesse Anderson. Late two on one. Anderson, power move to the front. They take a couple of whacks at it, and it is held on to by Sokolov. Linesman having to get in between. Got a lot of prowlers involved there as Chartrand throws a right hook for Stefan's face. And finally, the two sides are separated. And looks like they're going to have matching minors again. And they're going to go to 4-on-4. So Chartrand and Stefan headed over to the penalty box. Chartrand second time in the box tonight, second time for roughing as well. 2:58 time of the penalties. Want to see if that benefits either of the sides. So Jesse Anderson lost that one to Connor Foley. Both penalties being announced here, both roughings. And we'll see if that has anything to do with the remainder of the game. Hubert off the wall, gets around Liam Anderson. Played now across for Freeborn. Latest goal scorer here in this one. His pass blocked by Fitzgerald. And Jesse Anderson able to corral this puck. He's taken down. No call. Binghamton bench doesn't believe it. And Austin Thompson getting on the forecheck right now, trying to maybe spark this Black Bears team. Port Huron skates in. Johnson, a shot. It flutters end over end off the glass and out. Gavin Yates now 1-on-3. He's waiting for some teammates to catch up. Defense is going to go for a change. Yates stays on the forecheck. Johnson peppered by Kirkby. Having a hard time getting this puck out. Freeborn at the line. Makes Bond touch the ice with a nice little deke. And now the Prowlers are going to come back the other way. They don't like what they see. They retreat. Evan Foley playing in game 48 of the year, along with his brother Connor, who is still in the single digits in terms of games played this season for the Black Bears. 30 seconds left to go at 4-on-4. Bond with a nifty little head fake trying to get it over to Yates. Does make its way to the captain, Kirkby. Play held in by Bond. Takes one whack at it and then does skirt past the blue line as it floats back out into the neutral zone. Yates retreats. He starts and stops. Black Bears down by 2. Plenty of time left to go here in this one, approaching the 15-minute mark. Both players out of the box. Stefan and Yates rejoin the party. Back to 5-on-5. This is icing against Port Huron, and we will have an offensive zone face-off coming up for the Black Bears when we come back after this quick media timeout. Port Huron leads by a pair. Back with you in 60 seconds.
Mm-hmm.
Advancements in new clinical therapies are made possible by heroes like you. Velocity Clinical Research is looking for volunteers to participate in clinical research studies. Compensation is provided. There's a Velocity location near you on Old Vestal Road in Vestal. Learn more about participating and becoming a Velocity Medical Hero today.
Whether you're a high school or college athlete or a weekend warrior, Guthrie is the area's premier sports medicine program, offering injury evaluation, concussion management, physical therapy, and more. With a full team of providers across New York and Pennsylvania offering same or next day appointments, Guthrie gets you back in the game as quickly as possible. Call the Guthrie Sports Medicine team today at 866-GUTHRIE or learn more at guthrie.org/sportsmed.
Welcome back, everybody. Brooks Hill flying solo with you tonight here on the Black Bears YouTube. We will be doing the same thing tomorrow night in Motor City. Hanging out with Ben and Brady from the Rockers like I am Will tonight. Just located over to my right in his own broadcast perch. Back to the action. We're done with 4-on-4. Back to 5-on-5. We'll see how long we can stay there. Port Huron leads 2-0. Goals in the first and second period for the home team. Fletcher goes for the stick lift on Federley. Playing it around. Centers up. Nobody in the middle of the ice for the Black Bears. As Federley tries to thread one over to Scantleberry. Fletcher camped out off the glass. Nobody could get over to him. Lubert throws it back in. And Port Huron's offside. They have to touch up. Somero too soft on the pass as it makes its way off the boards. To an out-camped Prowler. At the offensive blue line, Chartrand leaving it for Foley. That's Evan wearing 94. Scantleberry trying to play the wall, get that favorable bounce that led to the second Port Huron goal of the night. Reversed around the wall, Evan Foley against Liam Anderson down low in the top right corner of your screen. Picked out by Kirkby and over to Weber. The Black Bears get this puck out of the corner. And are now across the red line. Shot from the halfway mark from Weber is caught by Sokolov. And he'll hang on with 13:43 left to go here in the second period. Greenlight Network's proud sponsor of the second period as always. This season for Binghamton, fast fiber and reliable internet. You can visit them online to find out if you can get their fast fiber internet at your house today by visiting greenlightnetworks.com. Prowlers win this one back, and Johnson now starts the breakout as it's chipped ahead by Port Huron. Fitzgerald easily able to reverse this one around. Walters fanned on the pass the first time. Low centerman, Tyson Kirkby comes in to lend a hand. Port Huron working the cycle down low. They get it back up to the blue line. D-to-D passing. This is now McCardle. His shot blocked by Yates. Getting in the way of that one. McCardle reversing one on the backhand over the glove of Mack and Anima. Prowler sustaining pressure here against Binghamton's top line. So far tonight, it's been the third line for the Black Bears that have done the best job, in my own opinion. And like myself and Cole say all the time, our opinions don't count. So second line in the process of coming out onto the ice, Tosto. Taking up some time on the clock and making life difficult for Port Huron to skate this one out. The Prowlers do have a hard time. In fact, Binghamton does such a good job, they force the Prowlers to skate offsides at the line. Black Bears splitting the season series last year with the Prowlers. Split the home games in Binghamton. And then split the four contest here in McMarin Place. Only time these two teams will see each other this year. Vaughn tried to skate in through the middle of the ice and said this would be just be dumped in. Sokolov plays this one around the glass. Steffen pinching in, sealed it off the plexiglass, but Dalton Jay now skating away with it. Beautiful poke check by Vaughn. Ahead for Thompson. He gathers it up. Back over for Anderson, a little interfered with behind the play, but a shot gets off. Sokolov made the save. Stones, wrister wide. Bond pinches in on the opposite side, and this one back out to the neutral zone for the Black Bears. Stefan crunched against the wall. Thompson, though, one-on-one with Freeborn down low. Binghamton just not being able to connect on that final pass for the tap-in goal so far here in this one. Prowlers just knocked this one back out towards Dan Stone, who was camped out in front of the penalty box. Chip ahead by Thompson for Fletcher. Third line out there now for Coach Sherwood and company. Fletcher couldn't maintain the board battle, and now Freeborn skating in for the Prowlers. Hits the trail man. Schumacher goes off a skate. Power move to the front, and McAnanama made the save. Now Fletcher over towards Logar. Two of the centers this year for the Black Bears playing winger tonight. We see Logar and Fletcher probably switch back and forth between who's going to take the faceoff draw. But as the lineup card that I was given reads, is Josh Fletcher is the true centerman tonight. Josh Fletcher being the left-handed player. Andrew Logar, left-handed as well. So two lefties switching back and forth. Somro is the right-handed winger on this line. Prowlers win this faceoff back, and Lubert fitting in quite nicely in his pro debut so far. There's a wrist shot that's blocked by Dan Weber. Falls onto the stick of Somero, and the Black Bears try to exit the zone. They're able to get it towards the red line, but they lose the handle on it as soon as they got center ice. Eber reversing it for Somero. Logar's got some space. He goes out wide on the left wing side. His ice cut in half by McArdle. I believe Logar was bracing for the hit and lost his edge in the process. Liam Anderson now playing it over for his defensive partner. It's JT Walters. Binghamton trying to connect with anything. This is icing as it does not touch a Black Bear's stick. 10:09 left to go here in the second period. Binghamton with 23 shots. Port Huron with 12. Two of Port Huron's 12, though, have found the back of the net. So faceoff makes its way into the corner. Gavin Yates will sidestep Scannelberry, and this shot from the point is well wide. Chartrand down low for Bartlett. Bartlett, nifty pass off the back side of the net to get around Walters. Now running out of options. Chartrand throws a shot towards the net. This one well wide. Even though it was from a dangerous spot, Kirkby could not clear on the backhand. McArdle throws a shot easily steered aside by McAnanama, though Port Huron swarms the rebound like a beehive, and a shot from Parsons. Brian Parsons, that is. Easily absorbed by McAnanama, and then a couple players get tied up in the crease. Looks like nothing's going to come of that. 9:29 left to go here in the frame. Binghamton with their work cut out for them, but still plenty of time left to go here in this one. Tell you about it when we get back.
The Black Bears are heading on the road for a while to close down the 2023-24 season, but they will be back at home Friday, April 5th, and Saturday, April 6th, to take on the Danbury Hat-Tricks. Make sure to join us for an action-packed weekend, and join the Black Bears as they push for the playoffs. Grab your tickets now at binghamtonblackbears.com.
There once was a ship that put to sea, and the name of the ship was the Billy O.T. The winds blew harder, bowed it down below, my bully boys blow. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. She'd not been 2 weeks from shore when down on her a right whale bore. The captain called all hands and swore he'd take that whale in tow. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go.
Should I get a COVID vaccine? I have concerns. Are there still health risks associated with COVID if I don't get a vaccine?
Does getting the vaccine protect others around me?
The answer is yes. Getting the COVID vaccine protects you from serious illness and those around you that you may expose, especially those with certain health issues. Ask your healthcare professional about your concerns in the easiest way for you to get a vaccine. Remember, it's not just COVID.
Welcome back, everybody. So that little scrum that you saw at the end of it resulted in, guess what, matching penalties once again. So we are back to 4-on-4. Dan Chartrand, his third roughing penalty of the game, and Liam Anderson gets his first. So we are at 4-on-4 for the second time this period. Mac and Animal temporarily lost a stick as it was knocked out of his hands, I believe, by a player skating around. Does regain it. So 4-on-4. A lot of matching penalties so far in this one. Fitzgerald stripped of the puck. Port Huron coming back the other way, looking for Leeburn on the back post. Instead, it's knocked away. Thompson now in a skate race, trying to go partially on the breakaway. Could not catch up to it in time. 40 seconds gone at 4-on-4. 8:50 left to go here in the second period, brought to you by Greenlight Networks. Black Bears still searching for their first goal of this weekend. Now Dominic Luber going around Weber. Weber does a good job of gapping up and taking the right angle, allowing the captain to come in. Linda Hand playing this one out to Dalton Jay. Now Stone lost his edge, trying to send Tosto on a breakaway. Give and go action for the Black Bears. Tossed though, a shot blocked by Jay. Nothing to worry about for Sokolov right there as his defense did the job. Johnson run into by Weber. Floated back out into the neutral zone. Port Huron's got a touch up. 8 minutes left to go here in the middle frame. 30 seconds left to go at the 4-on-4. Both players already standing up waiting for instruction from their two benches on where they're going to go. Jay tries to reverse it around off the skate of Weber. Foley now trying to thread it over to McCardle, read by Weber, and now the Black Bears skate away with it. Weber in front of his own bench. He's pushed down. Looks to be okay. And we have a penalty coming up against Port Huron when they touch the puck, slashing is the call, and the Black Bears are going to be headed to the power play for the third time tonight. So Connor Foley making his way over to the sin bin. He's got to know they always get the second guy. ...12:31... time of the penalty. Black Bears on a much needed Henny Hard Seltzer power play, and boy, could use a goal here to jumpstart the offense. They operate at 28.5%. That is first in the FPHL this year. This puck is held in at the line by Bond, but given right back to the Prowlers as they will skate away shorthanded. Schumacher out wide. Had it poked off of his stick by Gavin Yates. And now the Black Bears will start from scratch. Kirkby crosses over the line. Tosto, Logar in the bumper, drops it back. Yates out wide, his shot blocked. Held in at the line by Bond. Bond now skates into the faceoff circle, gets it to the bumper position for Logar. Logar has his head up, finds Yates. Back over to Bond, a one-timer tipped on by Tosto. Save made by Sokolov. Back over to the blue line. Kirkby playing catch with the defenseman, Bond. Now Tosto, moving it around the horn. In and out of the faceoff circle. Bond holding through traffic off the back side of the net. Kirkby knocked down by the goaltender stick. Still available. Logar whacking at it, trying to get his 11th of the year. Couldn't corral it. Mac and Animal stretch pass all the way up to Tyson. Kirkby But Tosto didn't get back in time. Play is offsides. 6:17 left to go here in the second period. 48 seconds left to go in this man advantage. Now the referee having a conversation with some of the captains of the teams on where this faceoff should be. And then they're calling for, I believe, somebody on the ice crew. Got a little shovel inside the faceoff circle. Got to make sure the ice is smooth and safe for the players to skate on. You never want to have somebody go through a rut. Could always be very dangerous. Just like you want to run a track on a dry surface. So it looks like that's been smoothed out a little bit. Black Bear still with 48 seconds left to go in a power play. Now we're finally back to the action. Second unit out there for Coach Sherwood. Weaver draws another penalty. And the Black Bears are going to be 5-on-3. That's in and out of the glove, and Sokoloff made the initial save. Cross-checking is the call this time, so the Black Bears will have 34 seconds of 5-on-3 time. And the new guy, Chase McArdle, with his first penalty of his pro career. That's number 55 for cross-checking at 13:57. So Binghamton currently on their third power play and also going to be on their fourth. 6:03 left to go here. Home team up by a pair. Could really flip the game on its head here in the next two-minute sequence for the Black Bears. Excellent wing play by Austin Thompson. The Black Bears win it back. Bond and Stone, two defensemen out there for the Black Bears. Bond a shot and a kick save made by Sokoloff. Kirkby over towards the rebound. 20 seconds left to go on the two-man advantage. Stone creeps his way in just to the top of the faceoff circle. Yates with a sharp angle shot that gets deflected. Out of play. So all five stay the same for the Black Bears. 10 seconds left to go on the two-man advantage, and then they'll go back to a traditional 5-on-4. One back again by Thompson from Kirkby. Stone holding. Across Thompson, looking for the captain on the back post. Gets deflected. Kirkby holding. Back over to Thompson. First man is out of the box. We're 5-on-4. Black Bears power play officially 0-for-3, but they have a minute 21. A 5-on-4 time now. So the 5-on-3 comes up empty-handed once again. Couple of saves from Sokoloff on the way through. Binghamton up to 27 shots on goal here. 5 minutes, 24 seconds left to go here in the period. So the Black Bears have won every faceoff in this power play sequence. But then Port Huron jumps the pass, and they're able to throw it out. Yates skates in. Going north to south. He's so elusive going east to west. Bonner shot just off the toe of Sokoloff. That gets the crew to Uwe oohing and aahing here. Nates goes off the wall, back across, works out for Logar. Logar's shot denied by Sokolov. Port Huron, though, can't get it out. Now Yates out wide, back over for Logar. Top of the umbrella, Bonna shot held on to by the netminder. And everybody grabs a hold of everybody. And Binghamton just not being able to crack Makar Sokolov just yet. .441 left to go here. This does take us to a media timeout. Black Bears with 38 seconds left to go on the power play. Back with you after this.
Advancements in new clinical therapies are made possible by heroes like you. Velocity Clinical Research is looking for volunteers to participate in clinical research studies. Compensation is provided. There's a Velocity location near you on Upper Front Street in Binghamton. Learn more about participating and becoming a Velocity Medical Hero today.
Toyota Trucks. Let's go places.
Welcome back, everybody. 38 seconds on a Black Bears power play. 4:41 left to go here in a second period. Black Bears are 0 for 3 on the man advantage. They've generated some chances. They're now up to 30 shots on goal. But just haven't been able to get the typical Black Bear shot, if you know what I mean, of just putting it in the perfect spot, taking some shots from some low angles and not being able to connect on the pass to leads to the tip-in goal. And it's hurt the Black Bears so far. Black Bears, though, win the faceoff back. Stone throws it towards the net. It goes off the back skate of Jesse Anderson. Weber and Stone, the two defensemen out here on the power play units that are already getting some shuffling going on. Anderson with an excellent lift to keep this play alive for the Black Bears. Played around the wall. 20 seconds left to go in the power play for Binghamton. Fletcher starts and stops. Lost the handle on it. Couple of players fan on it, and Port Huron finally going to be able to clear this one into the Binghamton end. Foley gloves it down. That'll knock off the final seconds on this power play. Thompson, though, skates in. And we are back to 5-on-5. Binghamton power play is 0 for 4 on the night. So Andrew Logar stays on the pressure. Anderson down low for Thompson. Tries a backhander. Didn't get enough of it off the backside of the netting. Port Huron to clear. McArdle fresh out of the penalty box. Chips it around Weber's, running out of real estate. Tried to soccer style it up to his forehand, but no worse for wear. Binghamton backhands this one out. JT Walters emphatically with his big man strength. Also some dad strength. Gets it back into the Port Huron end. Dalton Jay intercepts it now. Scannerberry comes in, and Mack and Animal had to be ready for that. That's only the fifth shot of the period for the Prowlers. Brian Parsons plays it into the open corner. Now Weber dancing around. Scannerberry centering pass for Jay. Nobody home. Back up to the blue line. Blocker save made. And then Stefan tried to glove it down, and his goaltender finally swallows up the rebound that was bouncing around. 3 minutes left to go here in the Green Light Network second period. Shots 30-16 favoring the Black Bears. Kirkby doing battle with Connor Foley behind Mack and Animal in the cage. Gives it over to the defenseman. Walters and Fitzgerald paired up tonight. Thompson able to get a handle on that. Looks like the lines are being shuffled a little bit. Thompson now skating with Tyson Kirkby and Gavin Yates, trying to ignite this Black Bears offense. Kirkby over to Thompson. Just couldn't connect on that final pass. Thompson has some space upstairs against Sokolov, who I've noticed has been quick to go down to cover the lower portion of the net. See if the Black Bears can pick up on that. Back over to Yates at the red line. Brushes off a light bump. Bampton trying to regain control of the puck in the process that they're changing players. Dan Stone got a piece of that, nullifying some icing. Both teams changing. Getting some fresh bodies on the ice for the final 2 minutes of this second period. Here comes Yates. Had it poked off of his stick by Decumbis, who started the scoring back at the 15:44 mark of the opening period. Chartrand, low angle, off the mask. Foley knocked off the puck by Fitzgerald, and McAnanima dives on top of it with a minute 41 left to go here in the second period. I would have to argue that the Black Bears aren't playing bad defense. And the goaltending's been good. Just a lucky bounce off of the inboards and a shorthanded breakaway, the difference makers in this one. Crooked number up on the board for Port Huron. Anderson skates, flying in. Liam Anderson, a backhander. Sokolov made the save. And then we got more rough stuff. McArdle putting Josh Fletcher in the headlock, trying to throw him down to the ice. It's really been the story here, second period. And the penalty box attendants opened up the doors, assuming that the referees were going to call matching penalties again on that. Kind of odd. So minute 23 left to go here. Black Bears power play 0 for 4. They're still searching for their first goal. Faceoff won back by the Prowlers, and McArdle starting and stopping around Anderson, able to get this puck over to his defensive partner. And Johnson now tries to clear, and the puck stripped away here by temporarily. Tosto intercepts for the Black Bears, played up to Liam Anderson at the line. Tosto a shot. Bounces around just over top of the net. And we got 1 minute left to go here in the second period. That was a funny bounce off of the wall and the boards. Floated ahead. Big hit laid on by Kyle Steffen on Johnson. Anderson stretch pass over to Logar. He will dump this one in. Sokolov gets a little bit of it to slow it down. Sommerone and Steffen. Two-man battle. Back up to the point. Walters holding his shot, blocked by Foley. And that one goes out of play. Into the safety net. Falls harmlessly down to the ice. Pierre Huron with the only goals to show for the game in this one. But the Black Bears, 31 shots on goal. Scannelberry. After the tie-up on the face-off, gets it over to Foley. Binghamton thought they had a chance holding that puck in. Prowlers, though, able to get this one deep. 15 seconds left to go. Final push for both teams. Logar takes a look up at the board. Goes across the ice while Port Huron still offsides. This is dumped back in into the corner. And Fitzgerald just going to play it away from all the players. Walters does the smart thing and tie it up. And that is the end of the second period. Prowlers grab one more goal. In the middle frame, Binghamton with 14 shots that period to Port Huron 6. No goals, though, for the Black Bears to show for it so far in this one. That's going to have to change. We'll see if the third period, which has been big for the Black Bears all season long, can continue to do the same. We'll take a timeout, come back from the Excite Motorsports intermission report right after this, folks.
Are you ready to take your billiards game to a whole new level? Dragon Billiards Instruction and Pro Shop has everything you need to impress your friends and crush your opponents. American Q Sports certified coach Kim the Dragon Young is now accepting new students. From novices to pros, the Dragon helps you find your best game with in-person or online instruction available worldwide. Need help with stance, stroke, or alignment and aiming? We've got you covered. Looking for advanced cue control techniques and trick shots? No problem. Follow us on Facebook at Dragon Billiards Instruction and Instagram at Dragon Billiards Kim for free daily tips and drills, upcoming tournaments and events, as well as exciting contests and giveaways. Subscribe on Patreon for personalized video content. Visit our online pro shop for the lowest prices on the highest quality pool cues, accessories, and Dragon Billiards gear. Dragon Billiards Instruction and Pro Shop, breathing fire into your game.
When you care about something, you take care to protect it. The family that depends on you and the future you're planning for them.
You'll have your own college stories too someday.
With sound advice, smart strategies, and a broad variety of life insurance options, Security Mutual can help provide for the people you care about and also help you reach your financial goals.
It's a sound plan. The time to start thinking about college
and retirement is now.
Security Mutual Life, the company that cares.
Get access to exclusive player events, monthly parties, and road trips to away Black Bears games. This is what you get when you become a member of the Binghamton Black Bears Booster Club. Stop by the Booster Club table behind Section 4 at the next Black Bears home game, pick up a 50-50 ticket, and sign up to join for just $10. Stay up to date on the Booster Club by liking their Facebook page, facebook.com/Binghamton Black Bears Booster Club. Monthly meetings with players, road trips, and a whole lot of fun when you join the Black Bears Booster Club.
Advancements in new clinical therapies are made possible by heroes like you. Velocity Clinical Research is looking for volunteers to participate in clinical research studies. Compensation is provided. There's a Velocity location near you on Upper Front Street in Binghamton. Learn more about participating and becoming a Velocity Medical Hero today.
Wanting more Black Bears hockey? Season tickets are on sale. Visit BinghamtonBlackBears.com or call the front office at 607-722-7367 to learn more.
You can experience gig speeds with Greenlight Networks. Our reliable fiber connection provides fast, affordable internet, so you can accomplish more in less time. We're expanding coverage in many places in the Southern Tier, and we want to be your internet provider. Visit greenlightnetworks.com and click on Check Availability to see if we're in your area. Greenlight Networks, fast, affordable internet in your hometown.
Toyota Trucks. Let's go places.
Welcome back, everybody, for another edition of the Excite Motorsports Intermission Report. Brooks Hill here flying solo, producer, engineer, analyst, and broadcaster here tonight. You can tell that the Chuck a Puck promotion is wrapping up here at McMarion Place. While we have the opportunity, let's talk about the stats from that period. They're brought to you by our friends over at Columbia Mutual Life Insurance. Protecting families in the Southern Tier for over 140 years. Shots on goal in the period still favored the Black Bears, even though they didn't have a goal to show for it. 14 shots on goal for Binghamton. 6 for Port Huron. Unfortunately, the first of those 6 was able to find the back of the net. And that is why the Prowlers lead 2-0. Binghamton power play, 0-4 on the night. They didn't convert on the 35-second two-man advantage or on the remaining 90 seconds of the 5-on-4. So unfortunately, if the Black Bears do lose tonight, you're probably going to be able to look back to special teams so far tonight not being the difference maker in a positive way for the Black Bears. There's still 20 minutes left to go, and the Black Bears are never out of a game by any means. They are not playing bad. They have just gotten unlucky twice here, one time in each period. Maintaining more control in the offensive zone, turning the puck over less. It's just all about capitalizing on your chances. So, that's our intermission analysis from me, Brooks Hill. Again, not that my opinion matters, but no need to fret. There are still 20 minutes left to go, and I'm sure the team is going to come out of the tunnel motivated here for this third period. We will take a timeout, come back, and we will update you on the out-of-town scoreboard and see what's going on in the YouTube chat tonight. So stick around, everybody. Out-of-town scoreboard and maybe some questions from the chat coming up right after this.
For discounted name brand clothing and footwear for the whole family, Homer Men and Boys Store is the place to shop. In business since 1951, our woman-owned family business is known for treating their customers like family. And there's nothing more important to us than backing every sale with friendly service. Come visit us to see the largest pair of jeans in the world. Come see what we have for you.
All about you make me think of good things.
Good day.
Like calming tempers down.
Good day.
Passing them around.
So stand up and cheer. We'll pass you a beer.
Good day.
Cheer a good-natured Canadian Pilsner.
Awestruck Premium Hard Cider, crafting transcendent, awe-inspiring liquid made and sealed right in Sydney, New York with New York State apples. Improve your day with Awestruck Premium Hard Cider. CryoWorks provides cryotherapy that uses nitrogen-cooled air to target specific areas of pain and inflammation. Local cryotherapy targets a specific area to deliver the same effects of the whole-body cryotherapy to that specific site. Treatments take 5 to 8 minutes, with a benefit exceeding that of hours of icing. Your Binghamton Black Bears, premier choice of cryotherapy, CryoWorks.
Stay in the swing of things with your golf game this winter and check out Fairways Indoor Golf Company. At Fairways, you can play any 3 state-of-the-art golf simulators. Enjoy your favorite cocktail in the lounge by the fire or watch your favorite sports team on over 9 82-inch TVs. The only slice you'll experience will be from the homemade pizza from the clubhouse kitchen. Bring your own clubs or use theirs. Get the golfer in your life a Fairways gift certificate. Tee off with Fairways Golf Company, 511 Hooper Road, Endwell, online at fairwaysindoor.golf.
Are you compassionate and interested in providing care to people with developmental disabilities? Check out a New York State career with Broome OPWDD. Enjoy great benefits such as job security, health insurance, retirement plan, paid time off, opportunities for advancement, and so much more. Positions as direct support professionals in the community or at a secure facility might be exactly the change of pace that you're looking for. For more information, call 607-240-4786 or go online to www.opwdd.ny.gov.
Go with a winner, Tech Guys Auto Sales.
have a huge selection of vehicles and every tool available to fit everyone's credit needs. If you've been told no before,
I say no when it feels so good to say yes.
Get the vehicle you deserve.
Yes! That's awesome!
With our guaranteed credit approval program, which can easily be filled out online at JeffKies.com.
Jeff Kies Auto Sales, Apple Lincoln, go with the winner, Jeff Kies.
Are you planning on traveling to Binghamton for an upcoming Black Bears game? If so, check out La Quinta Inn and Suites by Wyndham for a night away from home. La Quinta Inn and Suites is a short drive from the arena and is conveniently located off of the Southern Tier Expressway and Highway 17 with easy access to Interstate 81 and the Vestal Parkway. La Quinta Inn and Suites by Wyndham at 581 Harry L. Drive, Johnson City. Reach them at 607-770-9333.
Advancements in new clinical therapies are made possible by heroes like you. Velocity Clinical Research is looking for volunteers to participate in clinical research studies. Compensation is provided. There's a Velocity location near you on Old Vestal Road in Vestal. Learn more about participating and becoming a Velocity Medical Hero today.
Are you kidding me?
How do you do that?
Dude, I just got a new hot spring spa.
Carlisle has hot spring spas starting at $39.95. Come see how we make every day better by relaxing in a hot spring spa.
What happened to you today? You're shredding it.
Hot spring spas, baby.
Welcome back in, everybody. Excite Motorsports Intermission Report. Browse, ride, and buy. Free next day delivery to New York and Pennsylvania. Hanging out in the YouTube chat as well tonight, answering some questions. But before we do that, we need to talk about the out-of-town scoreboard. Find out what's going on across the FPHL here tonight before we get ready for the third period of tonight's game. Taking a peek around, looks like Danbury has a 3-0 lead over Watertown. Motor City with a 3-1 lead over Columbus down the road in Michigan about an hour or so. Carolina leads Blue Ridge 2-0, and Baton Rouge and Mississippi still searching for the game's first goal. So no score in Seawolves and Zydeco. Thunderbirds lead the Bobcats 2-0. Rockers up 3-1 over the River Dragons, and the Hattricks leading the Wolves 3-0. Black Bears find themselves down by a pair, but we want to thank you for tuning in once again to this YouTube broadcast. We'll be live from Motor City once again tomorrow night. So, let's see here. Got a question. How many Chick-fil-A sandwiches did I really eat last weekend? Actually, only one, and it was after the game Saturday night against Watertown. Of course, if you don't understand what we're talking about, go over to the Black Bear social media and watch one of the new videos that we've put out. Big thanks to Nolan Egbert, Dan Weber, Dylan Konechny, Colin Fitzgerald, and Josh Fletcher. They filmed some videos with us in those brand new Binghamton Whaler jerseys that you can get on next Saturday night, April 6th, Hall of Fame night at 7 p.m. It's also part of the downtown doubleheader with the Binghamton Rumble Ponies. So you can purchase a ticket that's going to get you access to the Rumble Ponies' second game of the season at 1 o'clock, and then tickets to the Black Bears game at 7 o'clock, Hall of Fame night. And opening weekend for the Binghamton Rumble Ponies. Big thanks to our friends over at the Baseball Diamond getting ready for their start of the season. So I only had one chicken sandwich, Gary, to answer your question. Truth be told, I didn't know Dan Weber was going to start talking when they said action. I thought I was going to be the one asking the questions, and we were just going to talk hockey. But Dan Weber had a different creative direction, and he just rolled with it. So that was a live reaction. And me just saying the first number that came to my mind. Let's see here. Brian wants to know, what's rivalry game for the Black Bears, Empire Division or Continental? Empire, 10 times out of 10. Empire games are more important than Continental games. Every game is important, but they're not equally important. Take that and run with that to the bank. Jeremy, Brooksy, go down there and get the guys fired up. Unfortunately, I cannot leave the broadcast booth. But I will let the coaching staff and the players motivate themselves. I do not know the game of hockey like they do, and they know more than me, and they know what makes them tick. Trying to see here if we had any more questions. You know what, Aaron? I don't know that. But you know what? Why don't you call the office at 607-722-7367 on Monday, and I'm sure Bobby or Kelsey will be able to help you out with that question. That was a good one. I don't know the answer to. So, we will take our final timeout of this Excite Motorsports intermission report. Get you ready for the third period, brought to you by the BJ's Wholesale Club, everybody. Black Bears find themselves down by two, but with 20 minutes up on the clock, anything can happen. One goal every 10 minutes is not a bad average to mark. The Black Bears have done that primarily the entire season. We'll find out if they can do it here tonight when we come back here on YouTube. Take a look, if you haven't seen the brand new Binghamton Whaler jerseys, coming up in this next commercial spot.
The Black Bears are heading on the road for a while to close down the 2023-24 season, but they will be back at home Friday, April 5th and Saturday, April 6th to take on the Danbury Hat Tricks. Make sure to join us for an action-packed weekend and join the Black Bears as they push for the playoffs. Grab your tickets now at binghamtonblackbears.com.
There once was a ship that put to sea, and the name of the ship was the Billy O.T. The winds blew harder, bowed it down below, my bully boys blow. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. She'd not been 2 weeks from shore when down on her a right whale bore. The captain called all hands and swore he'd take that whale in tow. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. Da 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 da.
Should I get a COVID vaccine? I have concerns.
Are there still health risks associated with COVID if I don't get a vaccine?
Does getting the vaccine protect others around me?
The answer is yes. Getting the COVID vaccine protects you from serious illness and those around you that you may expose, especially those with certain health issues. Ask your healthcare professional about your concerns in the easiest way for you to get a vaccine. Remember, it's not just COVID.
Welcome back, everybody. Third period brought to you by our friends over at the BJ's Wholesale Club over at the Oakdale Commons in Johnson City. Fans can still sign up for their membership club. And they can save up to 25% off grocery store prices each and every day. And added plus, not in the script, they have cheap gas. And who doesn't love cheap gas? So, Black Bears, down by two. We've seen this story before. Can they continue the plot and mount another comeback here in the third period? Let's find out. Third period officially underway. Here comes Port Huron. First offensive zone possession for either side here in the third period. Foley lost the handle on it. Dan Weber pokes this one out towards the blue line. Doesn't get it out. Thrown into the open corner. And Tosto able to glide it over to Weber. Now Weber skates in on the backhand, trying to find Tosto on the return feed. Deceptive little backhanded pass by Weber. But does not come to fruition for Binghamton as the puck gets thrown back in towards McAnanimal. Turnover right in front of the net. Active McAnanimal coming out with the poke check, keeping it away from poor Huron. McArdle, a shot steered aside by the Black Bears netminder. It deflected into the net and out of play. Game's first 53 seconds, wrapped off the clock. Yates took that faceoff for the Black Bears, taking a peek over at the bench, and since Connor Smith took that shot early in the first period, have not seen him out on the ice, and right now I do not see him on the bench. We're look to see if that changes as McAnanimal just puts his glove on top of that. There are some players sitting down behind the advertisement that I cannot make out. So we'll see if Connor Smith does return. Colin Fitzgerald ups the puck off the faceoff win for the Black Bears. Thompson throws it off the back skate of Freeburn. And Yates will have to allow this puck to come back into his own end where the defense gets set up for the breakout. Fitzgerald's off the wall, over to Thompson, hits him in stride. Almost hit him too well in stride as Thompson made first touch of the puck, couldn't corral it. Walters back over to Anderson, a shot off the wall, looking for that favorable bounce, couldn't get it there. Yates starts and stopping, draws the double team. Goes cross ice, Walters pinching in, a shot blocked. And this one gets thrown down, and we have a downed player. Looks like Alex Johnson, sore to get up after blocking that shot, laying all the way out. Well, the training staff out there for Port Huron as Alex Johnson makes his way up to his knees. Our trainer is Miss Bridget Smith. She's here last year for the Prowlers as well. And Johnson looks like he's catching his breath now. Took a heavy shot from Walters. And then might have caught a nick on the way follow through on the rebound as well. Johnson gets up on his own power and skates over towards the Black Bears bench. And for what it's worth for everybody at home, I do not see Connor Smith on the Black Bears bench now that everybody is standing up for Binghamton. So referee's having another discussion on where to drop this puck, and it looks like it'll stay in the offensive end for Binghamton. Black Bears trying to grab their first goal of the night. Can't score two without getting your first. Pushed over towards the wall. Anderson dropping it back for Somero. Somero couldn't locate it in time, and Binghamton down a forward here. They've switched the lines a couple of times here. It looks like we are going to have a fight. Josh Fletcher and Tucker Scantleberry. Each other out. Fletcher coming in with some heavy left hands early and just a wrestling match down to the ground. And Scantleberry continuing to throw punches in there. Linesman trying to separate them. Josh Fletcher with some words for his teammates. Maybe that'll get him woken up a little bit. So that came with 17:51 left to go. Apologies for letting the clock run a little bit there. There it is. It's back. So Fletcher and Scantleberry with 5 minutes for fisticuffs at 2:09 of the period. Let's see how both teams respond. Dalton Jay floats one, and a backhander gets deflected into the net. Binghamton looking for a high sticking call. If so, it's Jake Vaughn's first goal as a Prowler, and they lead 3-0. McAnima way out of his net. Looking for an explanation. And Binghamton's not going to get one. So Port Huron now officially leads by 3. So right after the fight, the next shift, Jake Vaughn deflects one above the head of McAnima, and it's 3-0 Port Huron. Play off sides at the line for Port Huron. 2 minutes and 15 seconds in the third period. Jake Vaughn from Dalton J. Say that one 10 times fast. So the Black Bears' hole got a little bit bigger on the very next shift after that fight. A very fluky goal that you can't really fault McAnima at all. They thought that that puck was going to get stopped for a high sticking, and it did not. It went right over the head of the netminder. Now Tosto, turn around, bid denied by the stick of Sokolov. Binghamton desperately pressuring to get on the board here tonight. Port Huron did not score a goal last night. They have 3 tonight, 1 in each period. This one gets deflected high into the crowd, and somebody is heading home with a souvenir tonight. So Josh Fletcher with all of his gear back on. Tucker Scantleberry with ice on his right hand. Binghamton in danger of losing a third game in a row for the first time this season. Freeborn behind the net, over to Johnson. He fanned on the one-timer. Thompson starts skating. Centering pass. McAnima made the save. Loose puck. Federley couldn't corral the rebound. Instead, Logar gets it over to Thompson, and he'll chip it out away. McArdle brushes Thompson away from his angle and off the puck. Johnson plays it around the wall. Logar gets a bounce off the referee's skate where Gavin Yates waiting for it. Yates over to Fitzgerald. He got handcuffed. And then Stone wrangled down to the ice. Linesman says plays on sides. So Logar and Thompson stay with it. McArdle giving a shoulder held in by Yates. Sauce it up ahead to Thompson. Stone looking for a deflection from Yates. Didn't get it. Fitzgerald pinching in from the opposite side. Prowlers to the rebound. And the team in gold skate away with the loose puck. Vaughn a shot. Blockered, and it goes off the net. And once again, out of play. 15:33 left to go here. Prowlers with a goal in every period so far. Stefan stretches it over to Anderson. Anderson, a shot fought off by Sokolov. That's the only breakaway or partial breakaway the Black Bears have had tonight, and Sokolov stands tall. Good shoulder save for the Prowlers netminder. Liam Anderson now stretching it ahead. Stefan brushing off a hit from Heinzel. Anderson right back on the puck. Had it wrapped off his stick. Centering pass on the wraparound attempt denied by the Prowlers defense. Binghamton touches up. And the forwards will go for a line change. Somero stays on as the high forechecker. And McAnanima out behind his net to play this one. Trying to get it ahead to Weber. Camped out at the goal line trying to get it ahead. Fitzgerald trying to stretch the ice. Couldn't get there. Hitting, starting and stopping. Loose puck. Shot above McAnanima's crossbar. Back up to the blue line. Schumacher down low for the captain and Foley. Cross ice pass intercepted by Walters. And the Black Bears skate this one out of harm's way. Tostow, give and go action. Weber coming in on the backhand. Centering up for Tostow. Blue paint. Nobody home. Prowler hit the ice in a dry spot. Kirkby a one-timer and a blocker save made by Sokolov. Maybe that one's his best save of the night. Hasn't been tested too hard. Walters threw a screen, hit a stick. Weber's camped out in front of the net. Three defensemen on the ice right now as Weber is cross-checked from behind. I believe Dan Weber took that shift at forward, folks, for the first time this season. Fitzgerald elevates this one out towards the red line. Johnson down on a knee to play the puck and keep it away from the Black Bears as long as they can. Fitzgerald skates this one over to Logar. Logar, though, cannot get it past Johnson, who was splitting the defenders. Parsons spins around, intercepted by Dan Stone. Knocked ahead for Logar, too far out of his reach. McArdle around to play it for Port Huron. 13:10 left to go here in this third period. Prowlers by three. Prowlers wrap it around the wall, far side for Bond. He tips it ahead on Port Huron, executes a line change. Liam Anderson back across for Dakota Bond. Too soft of a pass. Coming back, Ross Bartlett back the other way. And Port Huron headed to the power play for the first time tonight. Tripping is the call, and Liam Anderson is the guilty party. Fletcher will come out of the box, and Anderson will take his place. 12:43 left to go here. We'll tell you all about the penalty when we come back. Black Bears down by three.
Are you ready to take your billiards game to a whole new level? Dragon Billiards Instruction and Pro Shop has everything you need to impress your friends and crush your opponents. American Q Sports certified coach Kim the Dragon Young is now accepting new students. From novices to pros, the Dragon helps you find your best game with in-person or online instruction available worldwide. Need help with stance, stroke, or alignment and aiming? We've got you covered. Looking for advanced cue control techniques and trick shots? No problem. Follow us on Facebook at Dragon Billiards Instruction and Instagram at Dragon Billiards Kim for free daily tips and drills, upcoming tournaments and events, as well as exciting contests and giveaways. Subscribe on Patreon for personalized video content. Visit our online pro shop for the lowest prices on the highest quality pool cues, accessories, and Dragon Billiards gear. Dragon Billiards Instruction and Pro Shop, breathing fire into your game.
Welcome back in, everybody. Brooks Hill and the Black Bears on the Northeastern Striping Corporation for the first time here tonight in the third period. It's going to be a big one here as the Prowlers come in with the sixth best power play in the FPHL at 21%. So Liam Anderson gets two for tripping. Prowlers did struggle last night with the power play against Columbus. See if they can put one in the back of the net here and make it 4-0. Or if Binghamton can get a little spark here with a good penalty kill. Loose puck, Dan Stone plays this one. Off the glass and out. Referee right on top of it says it goes off of Connor Foley's stick into the crowd. .1206 left to go here in regulation time. First 36 seconds on the power play gone for Port Huron. And Colin Fitzgerald able to elevate this one out where Kyle Steffen gives chase. Wouldn't be surprised to see Binghamton try to go for a shorthanded goal here, down by three with just about 12 minutes left to go here in the third period. Now DeCumbis and Federley get set up for the Prowlers on this power play unit. Federley across to Foley, took his eye off the puck. Saw this last night with the Port Huron power plays. They just take a little bit too much time settling the puck down. There's the shorthanded opportunity for the Black Bears. Tyson Kirkby's going to skate in. Power move and a good poke check by Sokoloff if he got a piece of it. Kirkby forced to send it high on a shorthanded breakaway. Penalty coming up. And the whistle is blown. Oh, Tyson Kirkby wanted the call. Did not like it, and now being shown the door for an early exit. So Binghamton now going to have to kill off some more penalty time here. As Tyson Kirkby gets two for slashing at 8:55. So a 23-second five-on-three. And what I would have to imagine is a 10-minute misconduct as well for Kirkby at the same time. So Liam Anderson returns in 23 seconds. And then the Black Bears will still be shorthanded. Now Bond, 5-on-3. Dakota Bond comes on in. Backhand, he scores. Oh, goodness, folks. A 3-on-5 shorthanded goal for Binghamton. And they are not done yet. Folks, I have never seen a team score 3-on-5. And Dakota Bond just flew by the entire Port Huron offense. What an individual effort. Time of the goal, 9:05. Maybe that's the one to throw a dent in the armor of Makar Sokoloff. Liam Anderson has returned. We are at 5-on-4. So Port Huron officially 0-for-1. McCardle a shot, blockered away by McEnanima. Didn't know where the puck was. Ends up behind the net, and this one floated out towards the blue line. Johnson could not hold it in. Anderson goes off. Fletcher will take his spot. Black Bears in the process of a line change. So a shorthanded tally for both teams here tonight. No power play goals so far in this one. Port Huron still has a minute left to go. They try to center it up for Federley. Walters intercepts, and he's able to glide this one down the ice. Steffen, one-on-one down low on the receiving end of the reverse hit. Black Bears now with 36 shots on goal. It's a two-goal deficit with 10 minutes left to go. Chartrand starting and stopping at the goal line. Federley playing it around. Now 35 seconds left to go for Somro, who is serving the Tyson Kirkby penalty. Chartrand into the slot. Foley couldn't get the handle on it. Binghamton tries to clear, and Foley will do that for him. Binghamton will once again change. Gavin Yates forces a shorthanded takeaway for Austin Thompson. Comes out wide through the five-hole. Kicked out. Thompson broke his stick as it shattered. Didn't get enough on it. Dylan Konechny right on spot at the back of the bench, giving Thompson a new twig. Yates coming in. He's dragged down to the ice, and that'll be a penalty. So the Black Bears are headed to the power play just as they kill off the 5-on-3. Score down two men. And now they are going to the man advantage. 9:06 left to go here. We got a good ending in this one. Back with you after this, folks.
Advancements in new clinical therapies are made possible by heroes like you. Velocity Clinical Research is looking for volunteers to participate in clinical research studies. Compensation is provided. There's a Velocity location near you on Old Vestal Road in Vestal. Learn more about participating and becoming a Velocity Medical Hero today.
Whether you're a high school or college athlete or a weekend warrior, Guthrie is the area's premier sports medicine program, offering injury evaluation, concussion management, physical therapy, and more. With a full team of providers across New York and Pennsylvania offering same or next day appointments, Guthrie gets you back in the game as quickly as possible. Call the Guthrie Sports Medicine team today at 866-GUTHRIE or learn more at guthrie.org/sportsmed.
Welcome back, folks. Got ourselves a contest now. Black Bears on the board thanks to a shorthanded goal from Dakota Bond, 3-on-5. Binghamton back on the power play after Gavin Yates drew a call. Frank Schumacher in the box for holding. At 10:56. So Binghamton without their captain will try to get set up on the power play. They do have the player on the ice that leads the team in power play goals. That is Andrew Logar. Logar, a shot deflected and held on to by Sokolov. Makar Sokolov has looked good tonight. Hasn't been tested too much, but has gotten the big save when he needed it. Black Bears on the Henny Hard Seltzer power play. Once again here tonight, this is the fifth time. A power play goal here would really make for an exciting finish. McArdle tries to play one out. Federley on the backhand from the defenseman, able to elevate this over the head of Bond. And back into the Binghamton end. Easy shot that Mack and Animal will just steer from off target. Get set up for the power play halfway through this. Man advantage for the Black Bears. Bond almost did the same move again, coming through the defense, this time with another player on the ice for Port Huron. Thompson holds it in at the line, lets everybody get set up. Bond back over to Yates. Lost the handle on it, and that puck goes off the tip top of the glass. Back out. Binghamton, quick re-entry into the zone. Thompson now. Lambert, turn it over. Gavin Yates. Over to Logar, give and go action. Yates trying to cut in towards the middle of the ice. He's pushed off of the puck. And Port Huron able to clear. 20 seconds left to go in this power play for the Black Bears. 7:20 left to go in the contest. Thompson goes out wide, takes a hit, tries to make the play, but Port Huron able to get this puck cleared back over to Dan Stone. Final push for the Black Bears. 3 seconds left. Anderson stood up at the line. Man comes out of the penalty box, but Gavin Yates now. Down low, trying to go through the blue paint to Weber. Nobody home as this one will be backhanded out. Gets past Stone. Schumacher, fresh legs out of the box. Does a good job of tying Stone up. Couple of bodies pile up inside the faceoff circle, and Josh Fletcher able to calmly transition one out. So I can figure that Dan Weber is playing forward right now for the Black Bears. He's staying on. Fake the line change. Anderson back up to the point for Liam. Shot through traffic, and Sokolov hangs on with 6:31 left to go here in the third period. Binghamton power play 0-for-5. So Binghamton down Connor Smith and Tyson Kirkby. Dan Weber is playing forward. Anderson wins this one back to the other Anderson. A shot knuckled in. Sokolov almost had to kick that one out as if he was kicking a soccer ball. Thrown around the wall and down the length of the ice. They say tipped on the way through. Mack and Anima comes out to steer it. Over for the four, Kyle Steffen. Stretch pass over to Josh Fletcher. Fletcher has it on his forehand. He's wrestled down to the ice once again and then takes a heavy spill into the wall. Stretch pass. Scannelberry. One-on-one. Snared by Mack and Anima. He'll hang on with 5:53 left to go here in the third period. Face off, one back by the Prowlers, got behind. Their new defenseman, Chase McArdle. And Kyle Steffen peppering poor Huron right now. And McArdle almost has served it up on a silver platter to Somero. Somero in the corner, tie up with Foley. They're out there with Gavin Yates in the middle. Played off the glass into the skates of Fitzgerald. Starts and stops, gets it over to Steffen. Chopped ahead. Binghamton needs to maintain control of the puck here as we approach the final 5 minutes. Trying to generate some chances. Hartran throws this one off the glass and around the wall. Ends up directly behind Mack and Anima, steered around by Stone. Yates, starting and stopping, gets around the first wave of Port Huron Prowlers. Now Schumacher behind his net. Little miscommunication on who was going to play that. And Yates takes down Freeburn, touches up the puck. 4:44 left to go, and see, do they give that a penalty shot or do they say regular penalty? If you're the Black Bears, you'd rather have a penalty shot and be done with it. But it looks like Gavin Yates is headed to the penalty box. We're taking time out, come back. 4:44 left to go here, folks.
You can experience gig speeds with Greenlight Networks. Our reliable fiber connection provides fast, affordable internet, so you can accomplish more in less time. We're expanding coverage in many places in the Southern Tier, and we want to be your internet provider. Visit greenlightnetworks.com and click on Check Availability to see if we're in your area. Greenlight Networks, fast, affordable internet in your hometown.
For discounted name brand clothing and footwear for the whole family, Homer Men and Boys Store is the place to shop. In business since 1951, our woman-owned family business is known for treating their customers like family. And there's nothing more important to us than backing every sale with friendly service. Come visit us to see the largest pair of jeans in the world. Come see what we have for you.
Welcome back in, everybody. Gavin Yates in the penalty box for hooking at 15-16. Worst part about it is it's a two-minute penalty kill for the Black Bears. Their only goal tonight has been shorthanded. I think if you're Binghamton, you'd rather have the penalty shot and take the chance that Mack and Anima makes the save, and you just go right back to 5-on-5. So the Prowlers on the power play for the third time tonight. They are 0-2. Binghamton 0-5 on their side. Both teams with a shorthanded tally here in this one. And both of them on team's first power plays of the night, I believe. Freeborn at the faceoff circle. Over to Schumacher. One-timer, McEnanima ready for it. And here's Swallow up from the far side. No, that is not correct. Port Huron's shorthanded goal did not come on the Binghamton first power play. Excuse me. Came on the second one. So under 4 minutes left to go here, 3:58. Black Bears in action tomorrow night in Motor City. Face off, one back. And that one gets immediately rifled into the net. Dakota Bond with a shorthanded goal, 3-on-5. I've never seen it on TV. Never seen it in person until now. Dalton J starting and stopping. Prowler's power play, content to just take time off of the clock. Don't blame him, up by a pair on the man advantage. Shot thrown towards the net, steered aside. It might have been a little bit of friendly fire off of DeCumbus's skate. Bond ups the puck over for Weber. No icing due to Yates being in the penalty box. And Weber with the puck behind the net, trying to find somebody to center it to, gets it over to Bond. Back door looking for Tosto, a little bit too hard to handle. As Gavin Yates starts to make his way up to his feet here, 20 seconds left to go in his penalty. Thompson able to stretch it over for Fitzgerald. Fitzgerald's the secret weapon, holds it, and Sokolov has to cover up with 2:58 left to go. An offensive zone draw coming up for the Black Bears here. Approaching 40 shots on goal tonight, Binghamton is. They are at 39. Thirteen goals this season for Dakota Bond, who started the year with the SPHL's Roanoke Railyard Dogs. Turned into a point-per-game player for the Black Bears. Stone holds this puck in temporarily at the line. Final push on the power play. Foley trying to get it. Freeborn couldn't handle it. And Dan Stone up to Schumacher. Thompson with the stick lift as Yates does return out of the penalty box. Schumacher a shot and off the top of the shoulder of McEnanima. Right after the power play came to an end. First time tonight that Port Huron has scored multiple goals in a period. It's an even-strength goal. And now the Prowlers up by 3 with 2 minutes and 30 seconds left to go in this one. So the Black Bears are going to fall for the first time this season, 3 consecutive games, dating back to last weekend. Yates trying to pick the puck out of the corner. Bartlett throwing it towards the blue paint, nobody home. And now the Black Bears try to get maybe one final zone entry. No quarter given by the Prowlers. Now Liam Anderson, 1-on-5, throws one on target, it's steered aside. Chopped up high, but stays in play. So 90 seconds left to go here. We'll have a whistle, this one coming back for icing against the Prowlers. have to imagine the lineup will look a little bit different tomorrow based on who's finishing the game here tonight. So we'll wait and see what the Black Bears have in store for the Rockers tomorrow night. 90 seconds left to go here in this one. As the Prowlers elect to call a timeout here with 90 seconds left. Binghamton back at home next Friday and Saturday. Their take on the Danbury Hattricks both of those nights. Both of those games will start at 7 p.m. Or have the call on Black Bears YouTube as always, but we encourage you to grab your ticket, especially Saturday night for Hall of Fame night. Black Bears will be wearing the old school Binghamton Whaler jerseys. That'll be auctioned off live after the game. There will be a select number of jerseys available pregame. Only time they will be on sale is Friday before the game. You must have a ticket to the game to go and purchase the jerseys when the doors open. After the timeout, Prowlers will slap this one all the way around the wall. Decumbis will sidestep a hit from Dakota Bond. Binghamton tries one final clear to get it to the offensive side. Fletcher still marking his man as if the game was 0-0. He touches up quickly on the offsides call. Binghamton will drop their ninth game in regulation time here this season. Still a franchise record in terms of least amount of losses. And try to get back in the win column tomorrow night against Motor City. Shot off the backside of the net. Loose puck, and a penalty is going to be called here. And tripping is the indication. It's going to be Jesse Anderson tabbed as the guilty party. And looks like they're going to get a retaliatory penalty, too. Chartrand headed back to the penalty box for the fourth time tonight. So Chartrand gets two for unsportsmanlike conduct, and looks like we will finish the night at 4-on-4. 19-17, time of the penalties. Almost filled up the column tonight, if you know, you know. Anderson with the tripping, and then Chartrand with the retaliatory. Call not the night for the Black Bears. And the off-ice officials trying to sort this one out with the referee wanting the explanation. Fitzgerald off the draw, his shot blocked by Johnson. Still blocking shots up by three with a minute left to go. That is commendable. Ends up in the corner. Looks like we're finishing the night 4-on-4, folks. Walters down low to Tosto. Low angle shot from Tosto. Misses everything but held in at the line by Fletcher. This pass puts the Black Bears off sides as it goes outside the zone. Thompson skating away for Fletcher. Far side, but they're going to say that this play is offsides with 11 seconds left to go here in this one. My apologies, I did not update the scoreboard on the last Port Huron goal. It is now correct. Please don't be mad at me. Final push here for the Black Bears. Couple of bodies file up. And that'll be the end of that one. Prowlers defeat the Black Bears. 4-1 here in the only contest of the season series. Black Bears in a three-game slump for the first time this season, but the opportunity for them to flush that one down the toilet is going to turn around tomorrow as they take on the Motor City Rockers at 6 o'clock. Don't go anywhere, folks. We got a recap still left to do here. La Quinta Inn and Suites postgame show coming up after this timeout. Back with you in just a moment.
The Black Bears are heading on the road for a while to close down the 2023-24 season, but they will be back at home Friday, April 5th, and Saturday, April 6th, to take on the Danbury Hat-Tricks. Make sure to join us for an action-packed weekend, and join the Black Bears as they push for the playoffs. Grab your tickets now at binghamtonblackbears.com.
There once was a ship that put to sea, and the name of the ship was the Billy O.T. The winds blew harder, bowed it down below, my bully boys blow. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go. She'd not been 2 weeks from shore when down on her a right whale bore. The captain called all hands and swore he'd take that whale in tow. Soon may the wellerman come to bring us sugar and tea and rum. One day when the tonguing is done, we'll take our leave and go.
Should I get a COVID vaccine? I have concerns.
Are there still health risks associated with COVID if I don't get a vaccine?
Does getting the vaccine protect others around me?
The answer is yes. Getting the COVID vaccine protects you from serious illness and those around you that you may expose, especially those with certain health issues. Ask your healthcare professional about your concerns in the easiest way for you to get a vaccine. Remember, it's not just COVID.
Well, sometimes you're the egg, sometimes you're the frying pan. And tonight, unfortunately, the Black Bears were the egg as they fall here on the road by a final score of 4-1. Brooks Hill here on the La Quinta Inn and Suites postgame show trying to wrap this one up as easy as possible here. Black Bears, truth be told, generated a lot of offense. Not in the best of spots on the ice, I will say. Power play coming up empty-handed, definitely a difference maker here in this one as the Black Bears fall by a final score of 4-1. Take a look at the Columbia Mutual Life Insurance stat sheet here for this one. Binghamton out shooting Port Huron 40-24. They grab 9 in the final period to Port Huron's 8. Held Port Huron to single-digit shots in 2 out of the 3 periods, but unfortunately that's not a stat that really matters too much. Binghamton ahead in the shots on goal category by 16. But where it matters the most, the Prowlers got 3 more than the Black Bears did on the scoreboard. Only one goal for Binghamton tonight. It's unassisted from Dakota Bond, a 3-on-5 shorthanded goal that unfortunately will probably be forgotten about due to the result of tonight's game. A lot of penalties, both sides. Both teams 0-for on the power plays. So you can't say that Port Huron's power play beat the Black Bears. They were 0-for-3, and the Black Bears were 0-for-5. Both teams scored one shorthanded goal. Special teams played a factor, but it wasn't the difference maker in this one. 3 even strength goals for Port Huron. They scored as many goals as they let up last night after Columbus came in here and kind of had their way with the Prowlers up and down the ice. So, first time this year that the Black Bears have lost 3 in a row. It happens. Ask every other team in the league, except for Columbus, who haven't lost 3 in a row. Everybody else has. So, what are you going to do? You got to pick up your lunch pail. Get ready for tomorrow night. Can't let Port Huron beat you twice. That's the big thing. Got to come out ready to go to take on Motor City, because you know Motor City is going to give you their best shot. Let's take a look at the out-of-town scoreboard, find out how everybody did tonight. Some games still going on. Danbury leads Watertown 4-2. Motor City leads Columbus 4-2. That would have been a great opportunity for the Black Bears to get some ground on Columbus in the overall number one seed divisional spot. And Carolina over Blue Ridge 4-0. That game in the third period right now. Mississippi leads Baton Rouge 3-1. That game at the second intermission. So Seawolves over Zydeco 3-1. Thunderbirds over Bobcats 4-0. Rockers over River Dragons 4-2. That one just about over with. And Danbury over Watertown 4-2. That game also in the third period. We'll be back on the air tomorrow night in Motor City as the Black Bears take on the Rockers up in Fraser. I should say down in Fraser, geographically south of where we are in Port Huron. So, for everybody with the Binghamton Black Bears, Josh Williams, who helped us out getting the scoreboard up and running tonight, I appreciate that tremendously. And EJ Worth back home, updating social media for us with the graphics. I'm Brooks Hill, signing off. We'll talk to you again tomorrow, everybody. No need to panic. On to the next one. Excuse me. Black Bears will be back at it tomorrow at 6 o'clock against the Motor City Rockers. Good night from McMarin Place.